So during your short rest, did any of you try to examine some of the stuff you recently acquired or anything like that?
I imagine that Raph would have looked at slash played with the wooden bowl and the colored stones.
Okay, so let's stick with that for a minute. Playing with them, like, what types of things would you have done?
No. Rub them against each other, look at them, probably because he's not so bright, lick them.
Okay.
You know, you've seen a young child play with a bowl of stones before.
Okay.
Yeah, basically everything but eat one. He probably would not eat one.
So you got one stuck in your nose. No, I'm just kidding. did you count them or anything like that?
Sure. Now, did he get the right number when he counted them?
Give me a just straight intelligence check. If you have bonuses, on your intelligence check, you can. You think there's like 5.
Okay.
Okay. And then, hey, you guys, give me just one quick second so I can sort out my food, and then I'll be right back.
Everybody's talking about food. I'm getting hungry. Got ice cream and...
We just had pizza.
Phil went out for ice cream.
Yeah. I was just thinking, oh my god, it's winter, man.
Alright, you guys.
We still have ice cream.
Yeah, we have ice cream in the fridge. Well, freezer, rather.
Okay, so... Alright, so you counted your bowls. How about anybody else do anything during their short rest?
I would probably have meditated a little bit to sort of bring myself back up to speed.
Okay.
Swirling collars and everything.
I need to head in and buy some more arrows.
Yeah.
Yeah, we talked about that also.
I wouldn't have messed with my the sword until I find an opportunity to, you know, go talk to somebody that might be able to tell me what it is.
I can do that.
Okay.
As far as talking about arrows and stuff, I probably would have recommended, after that battle we just had, I probably would have recommended that each of us at least get one or two potions if we have gold to, and have somebody give them the money and have somebody gather them for us.
Okay, so we haven't really gone into town yet, though.
Nope.
Somebody hasn't gone into town to do that.
Oh, I thought we were right in this building right there.
We are,
Yeah,
we are, but we have just taken our short rest. Like, people haven't actually gone into town to get anything yet.
Oh, yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying.
But I'm saying that I can find out anything about any magic items you have. I just need a long rest before I can do it.
Well, okay. What do you have that can do that?
Identify magic and detect magic.
Okay, identify?
Yeah.
Gotcha.
So
I don't know, can I do any
slots?
Say again?
So you're saying you're out of spell slots? Is that...
No.
You can do some of those as rituals, I think.
Oh, I thought I only have... Identify is a ritual, but it's also a rogue level 1, and I have sleep and disguise self right now.
Right, but if you can perform it as a ritual, you don't need to spend a spell slot on it.
Oh, okay. Then I can do
fast.
Okay. I didn't know that.
Don't.
Cool. But then I can do it, and I was about to say I have the wand also. I like to check out, see if I can find anything about when there's time for it.
Okay. All right. So and then the last thing I just want to say is if you guys, and I think I brought this up before, but I'm at the point where I'm starting to work on, you know, follow-on quests and adventures. If there's something that really appeals to you, like, you know, some type of flavor, genre, whatever, that you would like to see, you know, send me a message later in Discord. And, you know, I'll take that into consideration when I'm, you know, building out future, you know, adventures, story arcs and stuff like that.
All right.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
All right. So anybody have any admin stuff they want to add before we get going?
Yep. Next Monday, I can't play because it's holiday in Denmark and I have my kids.
Okay. So I think last week when we talked about it, we were just going to go ahead and keep playing weekly for a while. I'm kind of up to date. Does everybody want to play next week as well? Or does everybody kind of
want
to take a break so you don't get burned out? What general consensus?
I think it's up to you.
Next week.
I think we need a take a breather. We've got some things that we're going to need to take care of, and we're running out of time slots to schedule them in. So if we could skip next Monday, would be great for us.
Okay, so that's like that's half the party. So why don't we take a break next week?
All right.
And then
that's fine.
Then we'll play the following week again.
Sounds good.
Okay.
Perfect.
Okay. Perfect.
All right. And so if you're ready, go ahead and we'll catch Steven when he gets around. And if everybody's ready, then hopefully you can start your feed.
Okay, I'll start now then.
People may just have to suffer through me eating for a little bit. So I just put a vote up. If everybody's ready, go ahead and check that and we'll get started.
Okay, Fee is up and running, and remember, I can see already you're hosting now also, and remember that to turn off your, if you're watching the stream or have it in the background, to turn off that volume so you don't get echo from that.
So it's there, but hold on, I'll let you know real quick where it is. So it's 500 GP plus 1d10 times 25.
From what?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry, for what?
starting gold.
Oh.
Okay. So. So 500 plus 1d what?
1d10 times 25.
All right. So there's my d10.
Times 25. Like 675.
And then you and then you get your own class starting and background only. The rest of you have to.
Yeah, I already have that. I just didn't have the.
So recap, the last time you guys started off doing some type of complex, underground complex, and tried to work your way through a stone door, and you got torched the first time, made your way in, Roth went in the hunt for food, burst through the next door, which led into an escalating fight with Deep Ones. Got kind of brutal, got kind of scary, but you guys got out of there and you rescued five of the kidnapped townspeople. As you decided to aggress out of the situation because everybody was pretty pretty worn out, beat up, bloody. You all start making your way out. You see up the street a crowd gathering at your first encounter with the people who were trying to kidnap the two kids. Up the street, the escapees go up that way. You guys work your way through town checking buildings and finally found one just to the north of the wharf that seemed to be empty. Made your way in. You now have your captives. One of the deep ones. What do we do from here?
Well, I would, like I said, I would, after we lick our wounds, I would suggest that we get some plies before we do something like that again. Some potions and...
Yeah, you guys literally drained
me. Yeah, so I would probably recommend we at least get one or two potions if we can afford it.
Yeah, how much do potions cost?
About 50 gold.
Seriously?
Yeah.
That's it?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yep. Yep. But they, I mean, you know, you can't carry so many of them. But yeah, 50 apiece.
How much do they weigh and how big are they?
I think they're like little vials, basically. Is that how it is?
Okay. Let's see. 50.
Well, you got to go buy them first. You can't just go at them.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
And you usually it's like a discretionary thing with the DM, how many potions he lets you carry.
Maybe me and L, if I remember correctly, is the best option to go get provisions without getting seen.
Technically, no one really knows we did anything wrong. That's why kind of why we took this guy and we stashed in this house here. So we.
Yeah, but we still left a lot of dead bodies in the streets.
Yeah.
Yeah, but they weren't human, so I don't think we have anything to worry
about. Yeah, it wasn't like, yeah, exactly. They're probably more worried about what the hell are these things than who killed them. Since I don't really know the party too well, I probably wouldn't know to ask you, Beldak, as far as identifying any of our stuff that we got.
No, but I'm saying it when I'm. That's why I'm asking now. If that short rest, could I use my ritual on that on the wand, and then I'm asking if anybody has anything else, or is it only one item?
I think I have something.
It's one object.
Sorry.
Touch.
Okay, so you did that ritual while you were doing a short rest. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
And which one was it? Identify? Is that what you cast?
Yeah, identify. Identify.
Okay.
Ritual.
And then Reese, you said it does one item.
Well, I mean, keep in mind, you have to look at your stuff because Beldak, if anything has a monetary value next to it, you have to pay that much money. You have to have that much money to pay every time you cast it, whether it's a spell or a ritual.
Oh, so you mean that we are using components, so I need to have a pearl worth at least
only
one gold?
Only if it has a monetary value next to it. If you bring up the identify in your sheet,
yeah,
it tells you one, it says... you choose one object and see how it has components, has a monetary value there, 100 gold piece.
Yeah.
You have to have 100 gold piece to spend each time you do that.
No, you don't. It doesn't consume the pearl.
Yes.
Or whatever.
Not the pearl. It's the monetary it does, yes. Anything that has a monetary amount is made like that on purpose so that people can't abuse it.
All right. Hold up.
You go ahead and...
Slight discrepancy because... If it has a monetary amount next to it, or like a component, and this was just the way I interpreted it when I read the rules. No. I always thought that it was that the spell did not consume. The spell does not consume it. So if it requires a pearl of 100 gold value or whatever, as long as you have a pearl of 100 gold value on you, you can cast that spell. You don't need to keep spending 100 gold.
No, it's made specifically so that you can't abuse it. You have to spend 100 gold piece.
Yeah, I think
that makes no sense. If it says it does not consume the pearl, then it doesn't consume the pearl. If it says it consumes the pearl, then it consumes the pearl.
They didn't.
It can't do both.
They did that. If you look at it, they don't all have monetary amounts. The only one they have monetary amounts. They're made like that so that they can't abuse them.
All right, enough of this. We need to make have the DM make a call.
Well, I think I remember reading something along that line myself.
You want me to pull it up for you?
Yes.
Let's move on. Go ahead and research it, and we'll keep moving on. But I think I remembered seeing that somewhere myself. But go ahead and find it real quick, and we'll keep moving on. So what we'll say? So what item?
I have the wand.
Okay. So, you have...
But I don't know if I could do more than one thing, or I need to find out how many things we have and what is the best to do.
Well, it says you choose one object.
Yeah, that's why I'm asking, before I'm doing it, if anybody has any magic items they need to... I know. Last time we did this to take magic, and we found out... I think it was Villarat that did something, and he was told that... The wand was lighting and two other options, I think, or one.
I have a mystical sword.
Yeah, I mean, you know, when you did the detect magic before, if I remember right, the wand you have on you, Belbak, was indicating some type of magic.
Exactly.
So do you want to identify that?
That's why I'm asking, the sword, is that somebody using? Because maybe that would be better to identify first, because the wand everybody can use more or less.
I'm not using it.
Okay, you're just carrying it. Nobody else is using a sword?
I don't know if anybody else wants to use a sword. They might use it if it's better for them. Like,
it was
but we haven't identified it yet, so...
It was a long sword, correct?
Man,
correct.
I have no idea.
I think Reese is carrying it, right?
It's on my character.
It
must be.
Oh, is it? So you're carrying it? No, I don't know. Let me see. I'll find
that. Just because, Reese, you're using a longsword and a shield, correct?
Mm-hmm. Trying to figure out. Oh, Marcone's carrying a mystical sword, long sword.
Yeah, a long sword. Reese, are you not using a long sword as main?
I think he's researching something right now. You might want to give him some time.
Okay, so Belbak, which one do you want to do?
Yeah, that's the question. If Reese is using a long sword as main, then I'll
probably... He's using a battle axe.
Okay, cool. Then I'll just identify the wand.
Okay. So, you spend 10 minutes on casting a ritual, and you get the sense that the wand, you know, the wand looks like this, first of all. And after a minute, you are able to identify it as a magic wand. A wand of magic missiles.
Okay, cool.
And it is fully loaded with 7 charges at the moment.
Okay. And it, same as the normal one, correct? You're getting one back, I think it is, or something like that, with a short rest.
Yeah, you'll see.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can look at it.
Yeah.
All right, great. So, we've done that. What do we do now? What's everybody doing?
I think we need to find out who's going to get some arrows and potions and so on.
I'll go. I know people in the town. I've traveled here before.
So Marcone, you would know that if you guys wanted to pick up healing potions, that you guys would want to go to Estee Lauder's perfumes and potions.
Oh my.
Oh yeah. That's where I get all my like fine scents.
No.
I need to hit the Fletcher.
So I should have like, okay guys, if we're going out again, we need to stop by this the potion person. And Estee Lauder, they makes the finest potions. The store is top notch. So if we want to get potions, this would be the place to get them. Like, you could probably buy some from like a sketchy guy on the side of the street, but I wouldn't trust it.
All right. So, are you guys gonna go? Are you gonna kind of split the party a little bit, and a couple people go different places, or are you guys gonna go on a group shopping adventure?
I'll split the party. I'll go. Actually,
we've seen.
I'll take a shopping list if people don't want to go.
Yeah, and we also have this one eye, or whatever it's called, in this room also.
Deep one.
Yeah, deep one.
No.
Yeah, someone's gonna have to watch this.
Yeah.
Okay. So. I can stay and guard the spooky guy.
Okay.
I have a small errand I need to do as well. I need to go to the... If there is a jeweler, I will go there.
You know, if you were to ask Marcone...
All right.
He would tell you that the most reputable person is Family Jewels and Gems.
Okay.
I thought you were going to say like James Avery or Tiffany's or something. So I relay that information. I was like, well, I bought this nice ring for this wench once. I went to Family Jewels and Gems. They got me a really good deal. Don't ask them where they get their diamonds. Say it's through your means, but I can show you a way if you want to follow me.
And then, if you were to go get leather, arrows, Amazon Provision stocks on.
That'll be where I'm headed.
Yeah, that's probably your best place. So let me reshare the town map for you guys. And if you look, most of those are identified.
I was gonna laugh. I was gonna say, Amazon carrying arrows, like they're an all-purpose.
All right, so let's start with who's going down to Amazon for business. Let's start there.
That'll be me.
Elle's going down there, or more, sorry.
Okay, so is Estee Lauder that way?
Estee Lauder is to the north, and Family Jewels, is to the north of Ash Grove. Okay. And Amazon, so that they're right across from 5 and 6. And Amazon Provisions is number 2.
So I would not be going that way.
All right. So anybody else going with Marsh? Sorry, or are you putting down a bright show?
I can.
So you show up.
I can stay back and guard this deep one, but probably one more is good to stay here.
Okay.
As I chow down on a ration, though, I want to say is like, look, you guys are going to be here. If you need me, or if you need anybody, let's just meet up at the Ash Grove after we're done. So, and meet up on the north side of it. And I'll be right out there.
The what?
The Ash Grove.
Won't we have healed up?
I spent
some of your.
Yeah, we spend almost already. Every. I think we spend almost every hit dice because we rolled 1, 2, and yeah. 3 max.
You're only 5 down.
Okay, so you get down to Amazon Provisions, and were you in the group that was there before?
Yes.
Okay, so you remember, let me find Amazon Provisions so I can remember her name. There we go, Lena. So you remember Lena as an old halfling woman, and you walk in the door, and she's like, "Oh, welcome back. Have you heard all the excitement going on in town?"
I may have heard a little about it.
Oh, it's I almost closed the shop to go take a look. I guess there's some weird fish-like people. They might be behind the kidnappings. How strange.
Well, I'm happy you stayed open.
Well, since I am, what can I do for you?
I'm in need of some arrows.
Ooh, you know, we just got some fine arrows in. How many are you looking for?
Eighty, 100.
Well, let me see. Why don't you stand right here and let me run in the back real quick and let me see what I can find for you. And so she would go search around back there for a minute. And she's like, you know, I was able to put together 80 of these arrows. And, I'll throw in a couple stragglers for free. How about 5 gold pieces?
Sounds good.
Great. And here you go. And thank you. Is there anything else I can get for you?
No, I think that's fine.
Well, thank you very much. Please excuse me for slamming my Western bacon cheeseburger in my mouth. please come back anytime. I think if there's nobody else, I might go take a look at these people myself. I've never heard of such a creature.
Just be careful out there.
Oh, thank you, dear. Thank you. And so when you leave Amazon Provisions, you head to the north of the Ash Grove. Is that where you're going?
Yeah, I'm going to join up with everyone else.
Okay, and as you're heading up that way, you can see, you know, a smattering of people heading up towards the scene of the first battle. Okay, let's do Estee Lauder in just 1 minute. As you get close to Estee's shop, he will meet you with, you'll be met with a sweet, fragrant smells that seem to overpower the stench that permeates the rest of town. It's a wood building, it's small, and it's inviting. As you walk in, you see a tall, slim human man with bright blue hair. Welcome, come on in. Welcome to my perfume shop. What may I do for you today? Hello, sir?
Esther. As I swallow down my food. I'm not here for the perfumes. Well, I'm not anyway. I don't know about these guys. What I want. I need to know if you've gotten any sort of potions about.
Ooh, I got all types of potions. Go ahead and give me a perception roll real quick.
That's gonna suck.
You're so overpowered by the smell of the perfumes, you're finding it hard to even concentrate. Who's there with Marcone? Anybody?
I think I've split off to find the jeweler shop by now, so.
Okay, so he says, well, wait here for a moment. Let me go see what I have. And he comes out and he says, well, I have these. I have these five little vials right here, and I'm told they're quite good of perking one up after, you know, maybe a knock to the head or something. But so I have these fives, but I have this very special one right here. And he shows you this other, which basically looks like a little bit darker colored red liquid than the one, than the five other ones. It's a little bit darker, and it glimmers, and the vial just slightly larger. He's like, I hear this one is the one you really want if you've really been set back a bit.
How much for the big one?
How about 235 gold pieces?
235 gold pieces?
Ooh, it's a bargain!
A bargain? I didn't know you were running a browbeating shop. God damn.
Sir.
I'm quite offended. I can assure you.
Well, I'm quite offended at 235 gold.
This is very special. I got it from a trader right off the ship myself.
Yeah, and how do you know that this trader didn't sell you faulty goods? Look,
well,
I'll do you a favor. I'll take it off your hands for, I don't know, man. Call it 175?
I couldn't even think of 175.
Fine, 200. But that's as high as I can go.
210 and you have a deal.
210.
Very well, sir.
210.
And how about these other? Yes, 210.
210 and I'll take the rest of your stock for, let's see, do some quick math. 300 gold. Wait, how many did he have? Does he have enough for 300 gold?
He has five.
And
he's like, great, very well, here you go.
Well, I'm mad at my way.
I'll tell you what. Okay, so this one for 210. I'll give you the other ones for 260. So 470 for the bunch.
That sounds good. Aren't they 50 a piece?
50 a piece? Who set those prices, sir?
Oh, I'm sorry. I just remember hearing somewhere that normal health potions went for 50 apiece.
Well, sir, you're very welcome to walk up the blueberry if you want to.
All right, fine. So, what are you gouging me for here, sir?
I am not gouging you, I assure you.
I know you're not gouging me, I'm just...
You are as offensive as your mustache, I tell you.
I had to bring race into this.
Race? You look human to me, sir.
All right, let me get out of this deal before I get into trouble. Here's your 470 gold.
Very well, thank you.
His mustache is his race.
It is a race. Don't let anybody tell you otherwise. I went down from 568 to 98, guys. Do you want to just drop that in my inventory, or how you want to do this?
Yeah. Give me just one second. There is that one. Let me make sure it ended up. And boom. There's that one. Give me a second to grab the other ones for you. Hey, Reese, while I'm finding this, do you want to summarize what you posted there?
It's in the thing there. I mean, it's up to you, whatever you want to do is what... But normally when they give the... Only when they give a monetary value next to the spell is it supposed to cost that much. But it's up to you what you want to do.
But it's also true what Steven is saying, that
Hero's Feast, it tells you it consumes that item.
Well, okay, so
I'm not arguing about it. I'm just gonna put it there, and you can do whatever you want with it.
Yeah, in the player's handbook, there's a different thing. So it all depends on what your interpretation is and how free you want to be with spells, basically.
Yeah. Okay. So here is my decision right now. I'm gonna say it costs you 100 to do it. Right now, we'll say the pearl is not consumed, but I reserve the right to change my mind when I have time to look into it more myself later.
Sounds fine to me.
Yep.
Because I know I've seen, I think I saw something in one of the erratas about this.
Yeah, and it might have been, like, I've just, which, all I know is Player's Handbook.
Yeah, I know I've seen something at some point, so. So, like I said, it'll cost you 100 to do it, Veldak, and you'll retain your pearl for right now, but I reserve the right to change my mind on that later.
Well,
yeah. I should.
Well, you are the Dungeon Master, so you can change your mind every time you like.
Yeah. Okay.
on my way out, I like sort of hit the door frame. Like I forgot something. I'm like, by the way, I picked up a nice looking longsword, Esto, and I was wondering if you might know anybody who's either a place where I might be able to sell it. I'm not really big on swords, you know, but I'm wondering if you might have some connections or something like that.
Let me think for a moment. To sell it. Yeah. Now, contrary to your opinion of me being of a more shadier side,
I would say that.
There is the blacksmith in town. You can maybe look at it. But I think you might do better if you took that to, say, I can't remember the name of the large city right now. Blaberry to the north, or the big large one. I'd have to look at the map real quick. But the large one up on the east side of Euro Soil. You know what I'm talking about?
Got it. Yeah.
Yeah. That kind
of... Thanks a lot, Essay. And I didn't mean a word of it, of what I said.
Oh, it's okay. By the way, you know that mustache of yours would look very nice with some color. If you want some color sometime, come back. I'll be more than happy to provide some dyes to dye that beard or that mustache.
Yeah.
I mean,
I'm thinking about maybe like some blues or like purples to go with the lightning god. But yeah, that's not a bad idea.
Well, did you see by my hair? Blue is quite fantastic.
It is. Well, I'll catch you later.
Okay. All right. So. Family and gems. Give me just a second to bring that up. Okay, so you arrive there, and it's a building made of a mix of stone and wood, and it's a bit disheveled. And looking through the windows, you're stepping inside. Immediately gives you a sense that this person is like a hoarder. It seems that there's very little organization in the shop. There's just stuff mix and match. Nothing is grouped together. It's a little damp in there. The light's dim. There's something coming from the back that just does not smell well. But as you're looking around, you hear something rustling behind the counter, and then go ahead and roll a perception.
Sure. Oh God.
So you hear some rustling, scurrying around, and you know maybe a couple of things being bumped in the shop.
Right. I'm gonna walk up to the counter and make a croaking noise like a excuse me.
And as you do that, from around the edge of the counter, a older male gnome who's wearing a very ornate and distinctive jewelry and very nice clothing says, "May I help you?"
"Ah, yes. I require some inquiry on a certain piece that I carry."
"Well, do you now?"
"Yes."
Please tell me about this piece of it."
"So it's hanging around my throat. It's behind my shirt. So I pull it out. I'm going to describe it. So it looks like it's shaped like a fireball. It's in silver. Very, very, very polished. Like to keep it clean. It's has sort of like a strange shape because it looks like it's supposed to be. It looks like the other half of something, and there's a strange glyph engraved on the back." That's basically what he sees.
I'm going to change up my gnome's voice because I just thought of this. So the gnome being quite small, he more sounds like Barry White.
"Oh,
yes, may I? May I take a look at it, sir?"
"Yeah, yes, that's voice. Fine.
And so he looks at it and he brings out a jeweler's eyepiece and he looks at it and when you hand it to him, he kind of shivers a little bit and he can visibly see kind of like a little bit of a shiver to him. He's like, "Ooh, whoa. I've never seen anything quite like this. I sense something quite powerful in this, but I just can't put my finger on it."
"Yes, this particular piece is, it's enchanted in some way. I have not been able to discern its magical properties."
"Yes, I definitely sense and feel that myself. I've never seen something exquisite, but it looks like it's maybe missing a piece that maybe would be helpful in identifying it. Do you have the missing piece?"
"No, that is my conundrum, you see. I require the other piece. But I do not know where to look. I require clues of maybe, perhaps, who this legendary creator of this item might be."
"Well, I'll tell you what," and he hands it back to you. "Give me just one moment. I might have something that might help you. Just give me one moment and I'll be back in a couple seconds. Please feel free to look around."
"Thank you."
I'm just looking one thing up real quick. And Steven, are you taking notes just out of curiosity?
I'm doing my best, but yes.
Okay.
And out of character, Reese, I stole your sword apparently.
Okay, so he can hear him and he kind of saunters back out. "You know, there is the school of arcane magic that is in, oh, darn it." And he walks back behind the counter and ruffles back there again. And he's like, "Yes, yes. The Warden City of Lenbrook, over on the eastern coast, the School of Arcane Magic is there. I would suggest you try there if you haven't been there already."
"No, I only arrived on the island recently."
"Oh, yes. And then, what was his name? His name, give me a moment. I will find this name for you." And, give me just one second. I will have his name for you. You'll want to look for Oh, yes. What is his name? His name is... Oh, his name is... Balfinal.
Balfinal.
Yeah, Balthinal. I'll spell that for you there. You may want to look him up.
Yeah, thank you. Now, how did you write it? Like, is that a character real quick? Just, oh, thank you. Balthinal.
Now, is there anything else I can interest you in while you're here?
Yeah, perhaps,
I have some fine gems here, and I have this fine gold ring set with some bloodstones.
Ooh, sounds fancy.
Yes, and then I have, well, I just, not too long, acquired this piece off a gentleman who came in off the ship, and it's quite a nice piece. Let me show this to you. You look like the man who would appreciate this.
Ooh. That is definitely a nice piece.
So, hey, out of character real quick. Does that
yes.
tell you what it is?
Yeah.
I think so.
I don't see it.
No, it's not.
It just says unidentified map slash image.
Yeah, sorry.
Oh, okay,
it has a picture.
Yeah, sorry,
okay,
I misunderstood. I thought you meant if the picture is telling us what it is. It's not saying on the picture.
Okay, good. Okay, good. Perfect. That's how it should come up. Can I interest you in this?
Well, what is your price?
It's a very nice piece. I paid quite a lot for it. I would give it to you for, say, 4,000 gold pieces.
Sort of cover my mouth. I sort of just sort of look over my shoulder and I. I'm not quite that rich yet.
Yes. Well, like I said, maybe I can interest you in this gold ring with the bloodstones. I'll give it to you for 250 gold pieces.
That does seem reasonable. Does it have any special properties?
Other than looking very nice, no.
Ah, I see. But I am a fan of jewelry myself. It might be of use later for enchantments. Scratches his chin.
It's always easier than carrying around in a big purse of coins.
That is also true. Putting my value in merchandise is a good idea. How about 235, and I'll roll a persuasion.
Well, you know, I like you, so I'll tell you what, yes, I'll give it to you for $235.
Good deal, my friend, good deal. Okay, I'll subtract the gold.
And here is your ring, sir.
Thank you. So, nice doing business with you. Thank you for the advice as well. Throw him an extra gold coin for it. The advice.
Okay, go ahead and remove that from your the money. From
that was 236.
Yep. Alright, so, anybody else, anybody, where, so you guys all meet on the north side of the Ash Grove, is that correct?
Yeah, that's where I'm headed.
Oh, of course I'll head over to the Ash Grove as well. Sort of slid the ring in my pocket for now.
Okay.
My multitude, I have a multitude of pockets inside of my cloak.
Alright, so you guys, as you, Morsari, as you walk up there, you see Marcone and Villarov joining together at the north side there. And why don't you guys hold off for a minute? So we have Roth, Strom, and Beldak. You guys are all back with your captive, is that correct?
Yeah, I'm using the ritual at that point, I guess.
Okay. And what about you other two guys? What are you guys doing in there?
I'd probably be checking out, talking to this captive, trying to get some information from him.
Okay.
Is the captive with us at the Ash Grove?
Oh, I thought we were still on the... Did we leave the building?
Well, Strong, you're still in the house, right?
Raph? Raph, Beldak, and Sturm are all still in the building with the Deep One. Right. Everybody else is at the Ash Grove.
Okay.
That's if I understand correctly.
Yeah, I didn't go anywhere that I knew of.
Okay. So you guys three are with the Deep One, and how are you going about asking this guy questions?
One question.
What approach are you taking?
Go ahead.
Can I do another ritual right away after this one is over and then take the sword also in that half hour? To 1 hour we'll be taking, since it takes 10 minutes to do the ritual.
Well, that's the thing that where I kind of agree with Reese is, like, you know, I think if you're just going to sit there and identify everything, I think it gets kind of crazy. So,
yeah, I have a suggestion. I have a suggestion about how to fix this, how to work it. But I wrote it down so we could talk after.
Okay.
So, out of character, just real quick, I'm on the sword thing. I would probably not feel comfortable knowing, you know, I don't know these people all that well. And then he's going to be doing one item already. I would just basically just keep it in my pack with me. And then, like I said, when I get though, I'll just keep it there. When I have time to get it identified, I will.
Okay. All right. So, all right. Okay, so you've identified the one wand on you. Strom and Roth, how are you going about what you're doing here with the Deep One?
Well, I'd probably pretty much stick to what I'm used to, is just pretty much getting ready to beat the crap out of it, information out of him.
Yeah, and Roth can help be intimidating.
Okay, and what are you asking him? And then go ahead and give me your whatever appropriate rules for your method.
All right, so of course I would have Roth there to be the big muscle behind my muscle, and I would be all intimidating. I would be, you know, basically telling him, I want to know what you guys were up to in there. Why were you, you know, what were all the captives in there doing? And were you guys making a feast for some, you know, are there other people inside under the church? Trying to basically get that kind of information out of them.
Okay.
And let me roll here.
Roth, do you want to use inspiration to re-roll? Or do you want to stay
with
the roll?
No, inspiration. How do I spend that?
So you just go ahead and re-roll, and then on your front page of your character sheet towards the top, you'll see little radial boxes. You can just
got
it. Select it. Yeah. And then just go ahead and re-roll.
Actually, I think you can select on any tab.
Yeah, right. I was on the skills tab when I did that.
Nice roll.
I'm laughing because I was rolling opposed to you, and you roll very strong, and I roll very weak. So, you guys are asking, and you can visibly see that he is shaken, and as soon as you guys start really kind of laying into him to ask him some questions, and he's really nervous, and you immediately start smelling more than just his fishiness smell.
Oh, and, God, you're disgusting.
Reminds me of a goblin I once knew.
Yeah. Oh, good old Drew. So he's like, don't hurt me, and he has this fishy sound. I can't even do it, but he's like, don't hurt me. I'll help you. I'll tell you. Right? Yes, it's under the church. I don't know what goes on in the church. Don't hurt me. Are you gonna hurt me? Because I didn't sign up to get hurt. I was
keep
just
talking.
Yeah.
Well, I. I'll tell you. So the people you saw were cooking us food. We have some slaves down there. Can I go now?
What are you doing with it? What are you doing with it? Why do you eat slaves? Just for the cooking? Is that it? What about sacrifices? You guys giving sacrifices?
Maybe one or two.
Maybe one or two?
Sometimes. Four, ten.
You're actually killing them?
There's been some we use to clean up, some we use for breeding slaves, some we take back under to our city.
What city?
It's very deep in the ocean. You weaklings could handle that. But basically, all I know is we're here to create kind of fishy human type people to help us.
Wait a second here. So you're crossbreeding humans?
And he looks to Raph and he's like, what do you mean by crossbreeding? What's this mean?
He's asking Raph.
Yes.
Raph glares at him.
I would definitely grab him at this point too. Hearing all this stuff. You're actually telling me you're breeding humans with you fish?
Yeah, from what I understand, it works out quite well, and it suits the goals of the, what do they call these guys? Give me just one quick second. I'm having a brain fart. Let me find this guy.
Too many farting on your brain.
Yeah. It suits the purpose of the Arch Mandrite.
Of the what?
Yeah, I'm not very good at pronouncing this. I'm going to type it. You guys tell me how to say it.
Archimandrite?
Yeah.
Archimandrite.
That's kind of his goal. You know, I'm kind of new to all this. I used to be a cleaner back in our city. I just kept everything polished, and they brought me up here. So, first day on the job. But yeah.
So Raph looks at Sturm and then looks at the Deep One and says, "You kill innocents, you cannot live."
I'm agreeing with you there, big guy. And what does he do after Raph says that?
He at that point loses his fish lunch. And seriously, don't hurt me. I I'm trying to help you guys out here. I just want to go home. I have a family. They're not human bred. It's just my fish family. Just want to go back and do that.
Where?
At the city, at our city. It's at the bottom of the ocean.
If we take you out here in this ocean right now and throw you in, you can go on your own way.
Yeah.
If we ever see you again, you are dead.
Oh, thank you. Yes, I always feel kind of queasy about the whole thing they got going on in there. It's kind of weird.
All right, we're going to...
They want to take over the town. And they think by this breeding program...
We're going to keep you here for right now, and then once everybody gets back... Once everybody gets back, we'll fill them in, and then we'll probably let you go unless you try something stupid.
He looks at Roth, and he's like, "Do I look like I'm stupid?
Please, try something stupid."
And then I go get a rag and throw it in there and say, "Use your feet or whatever and clean up that mess."
Oh, I'm very good at cleaning. That's what I did before. All right, so you three at the Ash Grove, what do you guys do?
Out of character, I put the sword back in inventory. So since it should have been in Sturm's inventory, but anyway, I look at everybody. I'm like, "Hey, did you all manage to find everything okay, given the directions?"
"I got everything I need."
"Yes, thank you.
I think I got some supplies that should hold us over next time we go spelunking or whatever. Well, do we want to head back and see what the group's maybe been able to reveal about our fine friend, our friend friend?
See if they've got him to talk?"
"Yeah, let's head back that way, I guess." So we'll head back to I guess not the hideout, but
our secret lair.
So we'd fill you in on basically what the conversation was, and it's like, these guys are not good at all. So I have no mercy for any of these other people. It'll be fine. I'm pretty sure Raph probably feels the same way. If we see these things, they're gonna die.
"You say the word and I'll kill this one."
"Well, this guy here is begging for mercy, and he assures us that this is his first day on the job, and he's normally a cleaner. So I'm not sure. We could either kill him, or we can throw him out in the water and tell him to head that direction and don't stop."
"Man, I have no idea what is up with you, big guy. Like, we were going to kill him before, and you had to go and, like, save the one."
"Well, I think he saw a little.
That was before we found out that they kill innocents."
"That's true."
"Yeah, they're like, trafficking, and they're, like, mating. They're like, making some kind of crossbreed things, and I'm pretty sure...
"Are they crossbreeds? Okay, so are they crossbreeds?
I think you said they're making, like, they're breeding humans with
they're making human fish people."
I look at him and I ask him, it's like, "Are you the result of a crossbreed? Like, if one of your kind mates with a human, do they get you? Like, do they get something that looks like you?" "God damn.
I think it's more human than it is."
"Yeah, well, from what I understand, and I haven't seen much of this, but from what I understand, they mostly look human till they're maybe in their, 2-10 years, somewhere around there."
"And I'm pretty sure he mentioned it nonchalantly, but I'm pretty sure he mentioned they sacrificed some of humans too. not him particularly himself, but in general they do.
Oh.
So these things.
So he just watched.
So everyone who's been taken is a lost cause now.
There's still people.
We're gonna have to go back in there. We're gonna have to go back in there and try to save who we can.
Well, it's a good thing I bought these, and I take out my potions and put them on the table.
So what's the vote, guys? As a group, man, with this guy here, you guys want to just do him in, or you think, or you want to throw him out to sea and tell him to start swimming?
Well, you know my opinion. I told him that last time. I think we should end him.
You should what?
Stop him from breathing.
You're talking like castrate him, or are you just talking like kill him? Like, I'm curious.
Stop him from breathing, or stop him from breeding?
It was very hard
to tell.
I thought he said breeding.
So there's no way we can use him in getting back in?
Oh, we're going back in. That's for sure, but I'm not sure he's going to be of any help to us. But we can try if you want. I don't know.
My vote's kill. We'll find a way in.
I hold no mercy for kidnappers.
You can see he's getting visibly nervous in his chair and fidgeting pulling on his restraints.
While we are sitting on the floor and crossing in the floor, cross for kill.
We need one more vote.
Oh, my bad. I didn't know there was actually a vote up.
So, before somebody does the dirty deed, I will go into him and say, well, seems that your fellow kind have doomed you to a unsightly death. I was going to let you go, but the rest of my group won't have it. So it is what it is. Then I'll walk out and let somebody else that wanted to do it go ahead and do it.
I will tell you, I tried to help you, and he's sobbing and crying. I tell you, Father Dragon and Mother Hydra will curse your soul.
I just walked out and then closed
the
door.
I walk up to him, and it's like, my God's already cursed yours, and I just slit his throat.
Alrighty then. And with that, he looks up at you, and there's a tear coming down his eye, and he looks at you, and his last thing is,
I hold him like I hold his head.
I had children at home.
And I go and I whisper in his ear,
you know why.
All right, well, you guys are down a captive now, so. He bleeds out.
I look down and I'm mad because I'm gonna have to get new robes.
All right, we need to at some point or another, we need to throw him out to sea or something.
The sharks lead him, I think.
All right, so you guys got some information. You got supplies. You got a dead deep one there with you.
I grab one of the potions for myself and the big potion, and I walk out, and it's like, sorry, big guy. And he's like, you can't save everybody, even if you want to. And I offer Sturm the potion of greater healing, which I'm going to throw in the party sheet.
All right, I will give you the money for that. I would
I don't need
get in there. I know, I would still get in there and dig it and give it to you. Well, how much did it cost you?
The potion of greater, that was 210. So if you want to split the cost on half, if you just remember who gave it to you when I need protection.
No, I would give you the whole thing. I would insist.
And then, yes, you guys can distribute the other ones however you see fit.
Okay,
I
took the gold
for myself.
I took the gold, Dave, off my sheet.
Okay, great.
So you're giving me the 210?
Yes, you can add it to your.
Okay, cool. So I'll go to 308.
And should I just take that from the inventory?
Yeah. Okay. Whoever's taking and however you're distributing those, go ahead and just grab them. So
I was basically giving one to everybody.
So Cyber Drake and L, if you go to the party sheet and the second tab down the inventory, you can actually grab that little brown circle and drag that to your inventory.
And it'll grab one of them every time you grab it.
Just so you know, I don't know why, but the party sheet is totally empty. We can't see all of the parties like normally we can.
He might not have thought, no.
What are you talking about?
I can
see everybody.
I can see everything.
I think he's saying you can't see what everybody's inventory is. I did that intentionally.
Okay, cool. That's just what we normally have. That's why I'm saying maybe that was an error. But that's perfect. And Dave, if you can check my actions bar, I made a new one just so I know it's correct about this shape-shifting. So you can see there is two dots again. I just called it shape-shift counts.
Okay.
So you get it?
All right, so what's the plan?
There's one more in there if somebody wants to grab one.
Do the ranged people really, really want it, or do you want to give it up? Give one up to frontliners. It's up to you.
Good.
I mean, I can pretty much escape most things with a word. So,
I think everybody ought to have.
I have one.
Something. Yeah.
I have one. Everybody should have one.
Okay. There's something wrong with Elle's character sheet. She's got three items at the bottom of her character sheet that don't have names. And she tried to take a potion and it subtracted one from the total list, but it's not showing up. So there's something.
So these are like just new empty items, so let me delete those real quick.
I have one, there should be four.
Okay, and then I'm gonna drop. Yeah, there's something I can drop it here.
I got room for everybody to take one.
There you go. So L has a potion in there.
Okay, so everybody should have one?
Okay, so right now, if everybody took one, everyone should have one, and Sturm has the greater.
But weren't there only like four normal
ones? No, there was five normal ones.
Oh, shit. I thought there were only four. I didn't grab one.
There were five normal ones and a big one. So everyone should have one if none of them are in the party sheet.
Yeah, I took one. I took the greater one. So there would be five others.
Yeah, I didn't take any one. I didn't take any.
Okay, hold on.
All right,
let me sort it out real quick.
I was just going to say have Raph put two next to his, since Villaroth doesn't want his.
Yeah, so Raph...
No, the only reason I said that is because I thought it was a limited amount of them.
Yeah, everybody could take... Yeah, go ahead and take one.
Yeah, okay, take one.
It'll help
the survivability of everybody.
There's enough to go around, and sure, I'll take one.
Yeah, hold on. Let me just drop one back to the party sheet there. Oh, wait, I may have just taken that one away. I did. Hold on. Okay, so I want to get one back to L. Okay, there you go. Sorry, I took yours away, but I gave you one. Beldak. Just gonna make sure everybody has one since that's your time.
I don't need one.
So how? So you have four. Did you have other ones from earlier?
No, I bought them at the beginning.
Who has four?
Oh, Beldeck already had some.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. That's right.
I used my money to it. That's why I'm saying I'm broke now after I bought, paid for the identify.
Yeah, okay. So everybody has them now. Okay, we're all good. All right. Now what do we do?
Potion of healing is 2d4 plus 2, right?
Yep. And if somebody got the higher one, it's 4d4 plus 4.
It'll say what it is in the description.
What are we waiting on? Let's go.
Yeah. Are you guys going back? So are you guys going back in the back door? Is that the plan?
That's where Raph is heading.
Yeah, I mean, I would say we would, like I said, we need to get rid of that body in case somebody comes in here, but we're going to have to come up with some kind of, you guys want to just storm in? You want to have some kind of plan of attack?
I would say we strategize.
I will cast good barriers before we're leaving, and then I'll hand out two to Storm, two to Marco, and two to Raph, and one to Morrissey, and one to Ilrath.
Okay. Yeah, they're basically, for those that don't know, it's basically good because there's this basically, somebody goes down, you can heal them a berry for one health point.
Yeah, I was about to say that, but no mind.
I'll just put a little note. You gave me two of them, you said?
Yeah.
All right, I'll put a little note on my sheet.
Okay.
I think I got
and,
two.
Okay, so I'm going to... Let me just do this real quick, and then I'll share the new sheet with you guys. I'm just throwing you all here.
So we decided not to rest, right? We did a short rest already.
Short rest.
Yeah, we took that, but we can't do a long rest until like whatever.
No, but you
we
can spend you can spend hit points if you hit dice if you want.
Right, which I already did. So okay, cool.
So Raph, did you understand about this good berries?
Don't eat these, Raph. These are for later.
This is for saving people's lives if they go down.
They would. I hope they don't smell good.
So
soak them in urine.
I was going to say, it's like, we have some of that fish shit.
Yeah, soak them in there. You know.
Oh, so it's nighttime now.
Well, it's very dark and cloudy. It's not necessarily nighttime, it's just dark and cloudy.
Okay. So
that's kind of cool.
So it's still like 12 o'clock only or something like that since it was 10:40.
Yeah, I'm getting ready to share a new time with you.
Yeah, okay.
There you go.
Okay.
All right, so then you guys should, everybody should see the map. You go ahead and sort yourselves out the way you want to be down there as far as marching order.
I'm not going to be useful.
And, so you guys got your marching order you want? Does everybody have the map?
Oh, I'm sorry. Marching order? Yeah. Hang on. I'm sorry.
Are we doing the map marching order on the map or on the party sheet?
On the map, because you guys are coming back
okay.
In the same door.
Oh, the map. Okay, I'm going to the party. All right, I was going to the party sheet.
I kind of thought that was the case.
Well, if I understand you guys right, you guys are going to go back in the way you came, right?
That is correct. At least that's the direction that Raph took off.
Yeah, we would have. We discussed it. Where Sevra's gonna go in that way. So me and Raph will be in the front. I guess we can go 2-on-2. I guess. have our snipers in the back. Alright, so we'll move up slowly, as you know, check and make sure that we don't see anything that looks unusual. It's been like what, a couple hours? Three or four
yeah,
hours later?
Yeah, just shy of probably 2 hours, so the weather's bad.
Did we go by the water or close by? Because then I'm saying remember to take salt water with to open the door.
Yeah, we need to get, I guess if, we'll have to look to see if this thing's still operating. If it is, we'll have to get some salt water.
Yeah, but if we're going close by, we can just go down and take it with us right away.
All right, go ahead and do that then, I guess.
All right, everybody, give me just a straight D20 roll.
Well, it's starting good on my dice roll again today.
So, you hear that big crack of lightning, and it hits down by the water edge. And you see, you can hear the sizzle as the lightning hits the surf break and hits the water there. And you see it steam in where it hit, but it doesn't even really land anywhere close to you guys.
Phew. Thank God we didn't fumble on this one then.
Hey, Marcone, that gets you excited, doesn't it?
That's my god trying to talk to me.
God is with us tonight.
That's right.
Whatever you do, do not tell him to speak up.
You guys want to just... Dave, you just want us to keep moving forward as we,
yeah.
As we go?
Yeah, just okay. Do as you got. Yeah, kind of do what you guys are doing and... So you get up to the door up there, it's basically like what you saw the first time. It's closed. Same story. There's the bowl and the door and a little bit of liquid in there.
All right,
probably
so
a little bit more in the first time.
We'll wait until Baldak gets back, and I will stand back just in case. I'll tell Raph, hey, big guy, stand back a little bit. You never know.
And when I come back,
right.
Then I'll hand this soul walk to Storm.
Go ahead.
Okay, what do I need to do? Because I didn't understand last time what you did.
Pour it in there. Do your thing, man.
Okay. Then
really
I'm
easily.
Okay, then I'm just doing what he's telling me to do.
Okay, so you move up to the door, and you see a little bowl, and you pour your salt water in, is that correct?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think you were there. I think you were there when we did it.
Yeah, I was just
lying. The door slides back and open. And as you open the door, hold on just 1 second. You see. Oh, come on. It's like truncating in the combat tracker. No one wants to see. Anyhow, go ahead and roll initiative. You see a deep one and a servant of the hidden deep standing just inside the door.
All right, let's go, Raph.
Wrong one, stupid thing.
Raph apparently tripped.
Yeah, maybe we're stuck behind the doors.
I'm just trying to figure out which ones. Let's see if this works. I'm trying to make visible the other one. There we go. So you see those two guys inside the door. And
you bastards.
Rolled. Marcone, you want to go ahead and roll your initiative? Okay. And so they hear the door open. As the door is opening, they're like, uh-oh, and they're like at the ready, standing just inside the door. Villaroff. here.
Okay. So, I'm gonna... If you want to do the... You want to keep the tokens open or locked?
No, I want to lock them. Hold on. Sorry. Thank you.
No problem. Just makes... There we go. It makes it easier to... pad out where I want to go. 15... 20... Yeah. I'm going to go there. I'm going to bathe the room in fire.
Dun, dun, dun.
Remember not to stay stand so we can't get past you.
Yeah, yeah. Give me a sec. So, Burning Hands. I'll just cast it. Did they fail or succeed?
They both failed.
Excellent. Roll! Ooh, okay.
And so the servant of the hidden deed, he, go ahead and you can describe his death.
Okay, so I sort of quickly run up to the entrance. I'm already charging both of my hands with fire. I sort of slide, and I do the whole Goku Kamehameha move. And I just bathing the whole, basically all, nearly the whole room in fire. And
yeah,
the guy on the left, he just disintegrates.
He takes like two steps forward, as he's just engulfed in fire, and his servant of the hidden deep mask that he's wearing just melts to his face, and he face plants right there in the ground.
And I'll move my rest of my 10 feet somewhere there.
Has anybody else ever read 8-Bit Theater?
No, I haven't.
Because you are now hereby known as Black Mage. Hadouken!
Can you move my character up to the door since I was opening the door? I was about to do it when you locked the tokens.
Yes.
I'll move 15 feet up to him, and then I'll attack him.
And you hit.
And he was ready already, so I don't get sneak attack, correct?
Yeah, they heard the door opening, because, the door is kind of a slow slide back, so.
Yep. And then I'll use my cunning and move away again.
Okay.
And then I'm done.
All right, and he, he's got some intestinal fortitude. So he is going to come out the door, and the first one he sees is Beldak, and he is going to slash out at you with his claws. And he comes out, and you're able, as you're backing away from him, he's kind of following towards you, slashing at you, but you're always one step ahead of him in backing up, so he's not able to make any strike on you.
Yeah, come on, a little more.
Okay, Marcone.
Marcone is going to
There.
Sorry, I was taking a drink. I'll move you.
Sorry, they can still do my stuff.
There you go.
Succeed or fail?
He failed.
That'll be my turn.
Okay. So he's kind of stumbling a little bit as you guys are all ganging up on him, but he's still in the fight. Well, sorry. Oh, sorry. Oh, there you go. Okay. Movie.
All right. Got the bow out.
You hit. And you nail him quite solidly up in the upper torso. And then you have a second attack.
Yeah,
right?
Second attack, same one. Obviously.
Second verse, same as the first.
And you hit again. And you put another arrow, like just centimeters away from your first one. Right there. So he's got like two sticking out of his chest.
Alright, boys, I made him a pincushion.
And then hit the down arrow if you're done with your move. And Strom, it should be you next.
Alright. So I'll immediately land with a battle axe. Oh, well. Hit him again, my extra attack. Ooh, and as I miss that, I kind of trip and fumble a little bit, and then I will go and take my shield and, like, bash him with my shield, corner of it. Bonus action.
Oh!
Nice.
Yeah, it didn't trigger, but all right. Still get your... And so what were you doing with the shield? Describe that a little bit.
Well, I kind of tripped a little bit, and I, as I was tripping, I took my shield and I just slung it and hit him with the corner of the flat part of the shield. Hit him in a soft spot.
Yeah, so you see as you hit him, like, his head kind of, his fish head kind of caves in a little bit and is severely deformed.
All right.
Rough. Raph. You go Raph or Roth? Where are you?
Either one. I mean, his name is Raffenkel, so Raph.
Raph, okay. Raph, take that.
But he'll answer to either because, well. Oh, wait.
I need to set you as target. Yay, it worked that time. So, and he's going to take a step forward and then go straight up Casey at bat. And apparently it's straight up Casey. Oh, hit anyway. Okay.
Just an informant. If you stand behind him, we all get flanking. And you all, so yourself, just so you know.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah, it doesn't matter at this point. You want to describe what you do?
So, he comes down the hallway, swiping at Beldak the whole way. He runs into two arrows and an axe. And so I just sort of step out and casually thwang upside the top of the head. So he gets hit with the shield going forward, so it rocks his head back. It basically into my shovel as it's coming from around from behind him.
Great. Well, I liked your description there, and I'll give you inspiration for that. And I liked how you included previously what was happening there. Alright, so he drops. And why don't we take this opportunity to take like a quick 5-minute break?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
Because I gotta use the facilities.
We could hear you almost right. Crying.
I must sully the latrine.
Yeah, I think we're gonna go grab some ice cream.
Cool.
I'm here, Dave, by the way, if you have seen my message.
I'm back.
Welcome back.
I'm here too.
Did you get a chance yet to see what I wrote you?
No.
Okay.
I'll just go back.
Tasty, tasty ice cream.
Screw you, man. I'm hungry.
Yeah, I'm not going to make a ruling on that until I can do some research after we play. So. I want to go look at the errata, because I think that was addressed in the errata. All right, so everybody's back. All right, so let me unlock your tokens again. And you guys just dealt with a servant of the Hidden Deep and a deep one there just inside the doorway. The doorway's open, and like before, you have steps that lead up, and you guys can free move.
All right, and I would even though it was probably pretty loud. Oh, we're fighting there.
I'm behind the big guy, but talking shit.
Now, are these doors ahead of us closed, or are they open?
They're closed.
All right, so now I'll do the same thing I did before. I'll go to the top, and then I'll just see if it's they're locked or unlocked. Like, I'll try to open it like really slowly.
Okay.
Just to turn it. I'm not going to try to open it. I'm just going to like turn it to see if it's locked or not.
Okay, and are you trying to be... I mean, I know you're wearing armor, but are you trying to be like somewhat stealthy as you open the door?
Well, I'm not going to open. I'm just going to see if it's locked or secured somehow. I'm not going to physically try to open it yet.
Okay. As you kind of play with the handle, you get the sense that the door is not locked.
Not locked? All right, I'm going to, like, I'll go over at Raph, and I'll just look back at everybody else and kind of, like, wave them, like, with my head. I'll nudge them up, like, waiting for them. I'm not going to open the door until they get closer.
Okay.
Those that are going to get closer, I guess. Which I would imagine would be the melees.
I would want to stick close, so...
Alright, and Marcon, you gonna stay back there?
Sorry.
That's alright. Alright, so now that I see them come up, then I'll open the... Now these are double doors?
They're double doors, and they open away from you, inward to the...
Alright, so I would tell Raph the same thing. I would, like, he'd have a hold of one and tell him to take the one handle door, and then we'll open them together.
And I just nap him on the shoulder and say, "Don't yell anything about eating now."
And I would like rush. I would like do kind of like a okay, here we go, ready, let's go, 1, 2, 3, and then as we open the door, we're gonna rush in.
Okay. So you open the door and you fling open and rush in, and you can see like there was the center table before has been knocked over from your previous battle, and you can still see some of the deep ones laying on the floor, and it's, you know, kind of a mess in there
right now,
you don't see anything standing living or anything like that at the moment. You do see another set of double doors to the north of you. And then to the east and the west, single doors where deep ones came out last time.
All right, so I'll quickly like wait for the rest to come in. I'll just stand at a, you know, like I'm standing at guard over here. And I'll kind of like, you know, say kind of like insinuate, you know, which way, you know, left, right, straight.
Well, they came all from all sides last time, so I guess we have to just listen and find out what, if we can hear anything.
All right, I see Raph going over there, so I'll just walk over with him. What do you think? You want to go that way, big guy?
I think so. The all one right, that came from this direction hurt.
All right, let's go. I got your back.
So Raph walks up and opens the door.
And as you open the door, just inside the door is another deep one.
All right.
And behind him is another servant. And go ahead and re-roll initiative.
Oh. All right.
Damn it. The dice do not love me tonight.
As I've said before, we're cursed.
Luck is not my lady.
Sorry, my cat knocked something over.
It's alright. I mean, no, it's not okay. But
damn!
That 20, though.
Okay. Somebody's playing the piano again.
Yeah, it's kind of annoying. All right. Anyhow, so everybody's rolled their
Raph like music.
There's just a little piano, a little overbearing. All right, so let's
see. Yeah, very much so.
More sorry, it is you this time. Can you hear me, Marcy?
Yeah, I got you.
Okay.
All right. I'm going to start with the Servant of Hidden Deep back there.
God for Spell Sniper.
Yeah. Can't play with you right now, dog. See ya.
And that hits.
Yep, sorry. I was distracted by a dog dropping toys in my laps. Yes, it does hit. And, wow, you want to describe your death blow on fragile little flower back there?
That was a perfect description of death description. You're just laughing.
One down.
Okay, so he gets hit right in the forehead and drops. Okay, and you have another attack, I believe.
Yeah. We'll take out his friend here. Well, maybe.
And he hit.
Maybe not out, but.
And so you have a strong attack, but he's able to turn slightly sideways and take your arrow mostly as a flesh wound. And if you're done, he sits your down arrow, unless you want to move out of the way or do whatever.
I'll go ahead and move.
Let me lock your tokens, too. Go ahead and move where you want to be, and then I'll lock your tokens. Is that where you want to be?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Beldak.
Yeah, I can't do much. So I'll hold my turn if he comes out.
What are you going to do if he comes out?
Yeah.
I will attack him with my sword.
Okay, so if he comes out the door, you're going to attack him with your sword?
Yep.
Gotcha. Okay. Strum.
Alright. So I will run in 20, 15 there. And I will, let's see, cart. Attack with my battle axe. Oh, nice.
Damn, wow. I love your dice today.
That one didn't trigger anything special either.
All right, and I'll damage. And I will hit him again, battle axe.
A regular battle axe Cuisinard.
All right, and then what I'm going to do here is, with my the bonus action, I'm going to shove him backward. Try to shove him backwards with my shield. I'm gonna like hit him with it and try to just push him backwards.
Okay, so and it, if you're successful, how far back does he go?
5 feet.
Okay.
So I'll roll athletics. You can roll either one.
Okay.
Not the best roll, but hopefully he rolls low.
Let's see where he's gonna roll. Hold on, I gotta. And he's able to withstand your push. He's able to put a leg behind him and brace himself.
All right, so then with that, I will still move back, and he can take an opportunity attack.
Okay. So there. He takes his opportunity attack, and he slashes out at you, and you're able to dash away or back up before he's able to do anything.
All right. And then I am done.
Okay, and then hold there for Marcon before you do it. He should have had his turn, but it is he? There we go. I'm sorry, he should have had his turn. I didn't have him visible on the combat tracker. So let me just back up real quick. So he would have came out at Roth. He's going to come back at you. And he is in a frenzied state at the moment.
Can I hit him from here?
Yeah, you can kind of go ahead and reach around the corner. Go ahead and take your attack.
Okay.
And you're able to kind of reach around the corner and poke at him with your sword.
Yeah, and I get sneak attack because Raph is next to him.
Not on an opportunity attack. I mean, not on a ready to action, you don't? I don't think. Or does he?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know the answer to that.
Yeah, go ahead and give Steve. It to him. I don't know.
Okay.
So but
you know it.
Okay, so I got it. Okay.
Yes. Unless you were kind of around the corner too, he would have been focused somewhere else. So.
Yeah.
Okay, and that's my turn.
Good job.
Okay. All right. So anyhow, so then he's, like I said, he's in a frenzy and comes forward and claws slashing everywhere at Rob. And he hits you. Do you have any reactions or anything before I drop damage here that I need to be aware of?
Not until after you've dropped the actual damage.
Okay, and then there's his, he hits you for 12 points of slashing damage.
Yeah. Okay, do I still have a this Stone's endurance, is that once a day? Nope, short or long. Okay, so I will go ahead and use Stone's endurance.
Okay. And that reduces it. Or no, you heal. Okay.
Well, it reduces the damage that I just took, and I couldn't find a way to program it other than as a heal.
Okay, that's fine.
We'll have to modify it if I ever heal more than the damage done.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, you can do up to, because it's your dice roll that depends, so working it as a heal after you take damage is, makes sense.
Yeah, but if he dealt, say, 4 damage and then I heal 10, I only heal 4.
Yeah, I don't think it'll let you go above that's max true. Points in here. So,
but I'm okay. Using it for 4 damage, I don't
know. Oh, yeah, I see. Yeah, like if you yeah. if you already had other damage, gotcha, we'll figure it out. Gotcha.
Yeah, yeah. All right. Anyway.
Cool. Okay, and then go ahead, Marcon. It's now your turn.
Okay, finally. I'm going to...
finally.
Can I see him past everybody?
Yeah, as you see, like, people dodging and weaving back and forth, you can see him in there.
Sweet. Then we're just going to go with a regular sake.
Okay. He failed.
Oh, bam! And that's the end of my turn.
Okay.
I summoned down the lightning. It's like flame with lightning bolts in.
Hey, Ralph. So seemingly out of nowhere from the sky, you see him kind of withering back and forth with some type of pain. A little light show above his head. Go ahead,
Ralph. Alright. I lost my page. There we go. Oh. I didn't have him targeted.
That's right, I'll drop it on. You hit him anyhow.
Nice.
Alright, and then second attack.
And I hit that one. Another big thump. And as you hit him there, you can see he's visibly a little woozy.
And then I will step to the side there that's still in range, so it shouldn't provoke an attack.
Yep.
Okay. That's all.
Do you killing
me? I'm just going to do my my classic, you know, the good old firebolt. Nothing fancy. I'm just gonna, you know, draw in fire. I'm gonna lob it at him really good.
And that is enough to
torch him. Thank God for double damage.
And so you want to describe how he dies in his fire?
Oh, yeah. Death? Yeah. So. So, I reach out, I gather fire in my hand, as one does. I sort of do this as they would do in when they you know, do the pitch for the batter.
Yeah.
I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna throw it, do a curve ball.
Nice.
It's gonna curve. It goes swoosh. Hit him right. I'm gonna hit him in the chest. When the firebolt hits, it sort of plumes around him and fries his skin golden. It smells. I'm gonna assume it smells really good.
Yeah. No.
Just falls backwards.
Smells like a rotten fish fry. Nice. Very good. Alright. Let me unlock your tokens. You guys are out of combat. What shall we do now?
I had to step away from my computer for a second, but Raph will just continue on down the hallway.
Okay.
Is that a corridor in the middle of the hallway there?
Yeah, so you go ahead and move. You have free movement. Go ahead and
I can't.
Oh, okay. I got you. Okay, I see what you're saying. So as you move down, I'm going to assume you move to about here.
Pretty much to the crossroads, wherever that is.
Yeah. Did we go? Is there something here we see? This little, is this a door or a window?
Yeah,
there's a door, and it's actually open. So here, give me a second. Let me open up some stuff for you.
Well, as Raph goes by, I would say, hang on.
Yo, Raph saw that. That's why he stopped there.
Oh, okay. He moved too forward in it.
Oops.
Oh, I thought we were talking about the corridor. Yeah, that's where I would have gone. I'd have gone right to that, where the start of that hallway is.
Oh, yeah, I was talking about this room right here.
Oh, okay. No.
So you,
Raph did not. Raph ignored that. Raph was worried about other things coming. Raph is checking corners.
All right, I just said, hey, hold up there a second.
So you, as you walk by the door and then Strom stops there, you look in. And it's just a small room. It's got a small table and a couple of chairs. And, you know, you being a city watch, you would recognize quite quickly that was probably like some little type of guard shack or something there.
All right. So I just give it a quick once over, then I continue to follow behind Raph and say, okay, go ahead. And I look behind, make sure everybody else is following. Before we continue on,
Raph looks back at Sturm. Which way? Straight or turn?
I look back at Beldak. Said, "What do you think? Straight or to left?"
I think we need to straight ahead to see what's up there first before we take any turns.
All right, straight.
Okay, give me just a second. I'll open up a little bit more for you. Okay, so you can see there's two doors down to the south of you and two doors up to the north of you.
Go down that way.
Down.
I point the direction. Direction like south.
Okay.
So just out of curiosity, for out of character as a DM, do you see any characters like poking up around there? Shouldn't it?
No, yeah, unfortunately,
yes.
We can see that one. Yeah. One.
You see that character. You see. Okay. I see that token.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Well, I won't do that anymore. Okay.
I hear something in there.
Yeah, I think there are kids in there.
We should knock down the door and save them.
Yeah, we need to get in there and save those kids, Raph.
All right, welcome to my world. Okay, so Raph goes in. You go into that room. Is that where you want to go? You're going into that room. Okay.
Is that a door there?
They're both doors, and they're
okay.
Both open at the moment.
Okay, this is the one I'm going to look into.
Okay.
First.
All right, give me just one second. So as you walk into that room, stand there just for a minute. Back to that layer. You walk in there, you see... right inside the door is a cultist who looks like, so this one looks, is wearing the same kind of set up as like the other servants of the Hidden Deep. It's basically a servant of the Hidden Deep standing there right in front of you. Go ahead and roll.
Since we looked in there, do we see anything else immediately around the area?
So looking in there, you see a bed, and sitting on the bed is a human captive with a infant. And then this servant of the Hidden Deep person was in there kind of talking to her, kind of like taking care of her. It looked like, you know, like a nursemaid type of thing.
You don't want us all to roll it, it's only Storm and Raph, since they're the only one there, correct?
I'm sorry, say that again, please.
I'm asking, do you want all to roll initiative, or it's only Raph and Storm since they're only one down there?
Well, yeah, just go ahead and roll in case we need it, so we don't have to stop later.
Okay.
For fuck's sake.
And I write those single digit init numbers.
So, Raph, as you come in, you surprise them, you can have a surprise round. And let me move the thing to you. You have a surprise round.
Oh, sweet.
Shit! Oh, man.
You're fucking kidding me.
Why don't you attack recklessly?
Did it activate?
So, yeah, it did activate.
Shit.
So, you...
Oh, no.
What were you attempting to do? Swing with your shovel?
Yeah.
So, as you go to swing with your shovel... what you do is you bring it like over your head and you hit the ceiling and it bounces back off the ceiling and hits you in the head. Roll your standard damage against yourself.
Oh, man.
Just go ahead and roll your standard damage and I'll apply it. Okay, so you... You do 9 points.
I even applied it to myself.
Oh, did you? Okay, good. So yeah, so you go to swing overhead, not realizing that the ceiling is low, and it's like clang clang bounces back and hits you right on top of the head.
Careful, big guy. Jeez.
And at that point, there's a lot of you probably won't be able to do much, but we'll go through initiative.
Okay. Well, don't.
I'm sorry. Oh, go ahead. Go ahead. Yeah, you got a second attack. Sorry.
Okay.
And you hit.
So, you know, he spangs it off the ceiling, bounces it off his head, and then kind of staggers over. And as he's staggering to the side, he manages to sort of poke the guy in the gut with the butt of the shovel.
Nice. Okay. And then you see you moved up to the corner. I'm going to go ahead and lock tokens at this point, just in case. All right. And we're sorry. Is there anything you can or want to do?
I'm just saying make sure we don't get attacked from behind.
Well, I'm way around the corner. I don't even know what's going on at this point.
Okay. So you're just going to skip your turn down at this point?
Yeah.
Okay. So I do the down arrow. Strong.
All right. So
I'm gonna give you another initiative, Mara. Sorry for recognizing and not metagaming that.
Alright, so I would go ahead and go in there and like I'm sure Balbac would see me going in there and attack, and I'll go in and I will hit this thing with my shield to try to knock it prone as a bonus action. And I will roll athletics.
Okay. And
ah, shit.
Where are we on this combat tracker? There we go.
Roll low, roll low, roll low.
Roll low. It's not a very strange. Well, look at the dice tonight.
I run in there and I try to hit him, and he's bracing for me. Or did it hurt him or her?
It's a her.
She's bracing for me, and damn thing, they're pretty strong. So then I will. That didn't do the trick. So I will swing my battle axe at her.
You hit.
And I'll swing again.
You hit. And you're going to describe your death blow there.
I hit her once and it did a lot of damage, but I immediately swung around and hit it again and it slit her throat as she fell down and gurgled with bubbles coming out of her nose.
And so you can see the human there sitting on the bed is shaken and quite frightened and cowering back into the corner, holding her infant baby, you know, with her. And saying, please don't hurt me, please don't hurt me. And you guys are out of combat at this point.
Okay, so I would tell Raph, since this is a female, I'd tell Raph, said, go get Marisari, please. And I would put my, sheath my weapons for now and say, it's okay. Is the baby, knowing what I know what they were doing, I'm not gonna like go up and grab the baby or nothing. I'm just gonna like try to look at the baby to see if I can notice anything unusual about it.
Roll a perception.
Since I already know that they're doing this kind of stuff.
So this baby looks like a normal human infant to you.
So as Marisari walks in, I say, so she's pretty shook up. I thought maybe she might feel more comfortable if you talk to her, maybe. That's real big brutes.
So she's like, help me. Who are you? Don't hurt me. She doesn't say help me. I'm sorry. Her gut can be hurt. Don't hurt me. Don't hurt me. Who are you? Don't hurt me.
We're not here to hear you.
Damn, Cyber, you're going into her when she's speaking all the time.
I'm sorry, what?
Cyber's microphone is activating when...
My microphone is off.
So weird.
Give me one second.
Just turn her, if it's too loud for you... Baldak, just turn the
no, it's not that. It's not too loud. It's just like when Ella's speaking, I can see that Cyber is also activating at the same time.
But he doesn't have his on. He's on press to talk.
Okay, hey, give me 2 minutes. I'll be right back.
Alright.
Yeah, that's why it's so weird if he has push to talk and it's not activating. Why is it activating? That's what I'm saying. Because I have Discord open on my third...
That makes no sense at all. We're on two different systems.
Exactly. That's why it's so weird, because I have Discord open so I can see every time people are speaking.
It's... Yeah. Eh, whatever. Doesn't really matter. I would, more quietly, I would say, to take a look at that baby. Thinking maybe it might be a hybrid.
I'm not sure what I could tell about it, but I'll give it a try.
Yeah. We already know that they were breeding these things with humans. I'm wondering if this is one of the offspring.
Dave, are you back?
I don't think so.
Okay. Yeah, I don't know what's up on your Discord, but when I'm lit up here, he's not lit up on my screen at all.
No, he's not now, but sometimes, just a few times, it is, and then you can hear the echo.
That's really bizarre.
Yeah, but I'm pretty sure if you go to YouTube on my channel, after when I upload it, you can hear it, because it's just echoing sometimes, and that's every time when Cyber is activating the same time as you.
Okay.
If she happens to be trying to speak at the same time that I happen to be trying to speak, it's going to happen, and there's really not much we can do about it.
No, true.
Yeah.
Okay, Dave, you're back.
Yeah, we're in the same room together, so there's not... If he's got his pressed and I've got mine pressed at the same time, there's going to be an echo.
How dare you?
No worries.
Life in the same room? That's...
Okay, moving on. Anyhow.
So, all right. So, Morisari will ask her if it's okay if I look at the baby. I just want to check and make sure that it's healthy.
Are you going to take my baby? I'm not going to take it away.
I just want to have a good look at it and make sure that it's okay.
Okay. So she will reluctantly hand... Well, first of all, are you trying to persuade her? So roll a persuasion.
Hang on here.
How old is that child looking? Or female? With the kid?
So you're able to... convince her, and she's like, don't hurt my baby, don't hurt my baby. And she
I promise I won't hurt it.
And she hands it over. She's like, help me get out of here, help me get out of here.
That's what we're here for.
Okay, and then are you looking the baby over?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead and give it an investigation roll.
Okay. It'd be investigator insight.
Investigate, because you're kind of looking, looking the baby over.
Okay.
Shit.
And so, you're looking the baby over, and you know it's obvious this baby's probably only a day or two old, and but it looks like every other human baby you've seen. Nothing looks unusual.
Can I see that little child? That's very tiny.
The baby?
Yeah.
No, the baby's a normal baby size.
No, I'm saying, can I see that little child? It's very tiny.
Is it all right if he looks at it?
She is very nervous.
How about if I hold the baby while he looks?
That's okay. Just go ahead and then give me my baby. Look and give it back. Help me out of here.
I'll take a look.
Okay. You roll investigation.
We're good at all those dice.
As you are looking over the baby does what babies do at this age, and like just tinkles straight up in the air, like just a fountain shooting just straight up in the air. But she knows there's nothing other than what a normal baby is.
Okay.
And she said, "Can I have my baby? Please give me my baby and help me get out of here."
We'll get a priest here to check out to see if there's anything wrong. But I think it's perfect.
You can let her have her baby back for now. We're waiting on a doctor. I'll just say like a doctor.
So Raph goes, he gets Marcone.
Hey, Marcone, go over and take a look. We
I'll hand the baby back to her, and Marcone can look at the baby in her arms.
So yeah, that's fine. I don't need to see the baby. GM, can guidance affect yourself?
Yeah.
Do you know? Or Sturm, do you know?
Well, it's a touch thing, right?
Yeah.
It's cast, it's a range of self.
I don't think you can.
Okay, it's a range of touch. I don't know.
I think
if you
have to
touch
do
yourself.
It with somebody else.
Okay.
It should tell you, actually.
Yeah.
It just saying touch, and we talked about it when I talked last time, that it's okay to use them on yourself because you also...
It's one willing creature.
Yeah.
So, this is what I'm going to do.
Okay.
I'm going to... I look at the baby, and I was like, you know what, let me get a second opinion. Vilaroth, and I start saying some prayers, and as Vilaroth comes over, I cast guidance on him, which gives him...
You're a willing creature, you can do it on yourself.
So
I know, but he has a better investigation.
I'm sorry.
So a couple of you guys have physically investigated this baby. At this point, if you want to roll insight, like as a gut feeling, you can. I'll let you use insight as like, you know, what your gut feeling kind of is.
Well, I'm not gonna roll because I would have wanted Marcone to look at her. So I'll let him do it.
So, I'm not gonna hold on. Not everybody roll, but I mean, you know, if you've looked at the baby, you've looked at the baby and Marcone, you're kind of looking. So you physically don't see any difference than a human baby. But you get this hint, like, hey, this lady's in here with a baby. You've heard the rumors.
She was being looked after, you know.
Yeah. Yeah. You guys have a good sense that this is probably a hybrid baby.
Yeah.
But physically, you're not going to be able to tell that.
Okay.
And, I mean, the guy said, was I there when the guy said, like...
We told you about it.
He told you.
Yeah. It's like, signs aren't going to show until they hit... puberty.
All right, guys. I know we need to get... Okay, we have two... look like we have two options here. Either one of us takes her and her baby out to town area, or we keep her here and we come back for her.
Yeah, that's if we keep her here, she's just...
You know, okay. Out to town isn't that far.
We can't keep... Okay. At this time, Marcone's going to interrupt and say, look, we can't, every time we find one person, they're going to want us to help them escape, and we are going to help them escape, but here's the deal, is we cannot keep going back and forth.
No.
Well, I agree.
Just let them go. We already opened the door for them. Just tell them they can run this way out, and then tell them.
Or if they want our protection, they can meet us, like, over in the hall that we cleared.
Right. Well, the only reason I'm a little more worried about Justin is because this is a
I understand why you're worried.
Like, woman with a young baby.
Okay. I thought we were going a different direction. I just didn't want you to say it. Yeah, I understand your concerns. And definitely we want to keep note of that. And any other survivors that have young children.
Are you from the town?
Yes.
And in what family? No, the female with the child.
Yes, I was from town. I was taken from town. I don't know how long. It seems like I've been here forever.
But with family,
we need to go and get the rest of the survivors.
Yeah.
Well, that might answer a question.
All right. Continue your question.
But what family are you from?
What was the question?
What family are you from?
I'm from the Smith family in town.
I'm just trying to get information so we can get back to her at some point, out of character.
Yeah. She's nobody significant in town. So, you know, there's nobody you've met yet but she's like, yeah, I was kidnapped. It seems like forever ago. I've been here for I don't know how long. I wasn't pregnant when I came here.
Okay. You have two options.
And she'll tell you, she's like, She's like, they raped me, they raped me. I don't even fully remember what happened, but this is my baby.
Yeah, okay. You have two options now. You can stay here or stay behind us, or you can run all the way out by yourself.
Yeah.
Because
no,
the door
she can't
is
go
open.
Behind. She can't go behind us.
No, I mean way behind, like in this room till we have cleared more areas around. But the door is open, so you can also just run out.
Can you just make sure I get how do I get out? Can get me out of here safely?
I'll just tell her straight ahead and then to the right. Then you can feel the breeze up there.
Why don't we just take her to the door?
Because, like we said, we can't do that all the time. We have to move on.
All right, guys, let's. I come in the room here. I'm like, we gotta get going. Just go ahead and this one here is not that far away. Let's just go and then point her in a direction. And then, Miss, you need to go and immediately see the. Do you have a doctor you normally go to?
Yeah, I can't afford a doctor.
Don't worry about that. Just go there, take your baby, and explain what happened, and we'll make sure.
I'll go to the town hall or the city watch barracks.
I give her one gold piece, and then I tell her the way out.
Okay, so you guys. Okay, so you do you show her the way out, or you let her kind of run?
Okay, so since this is real close, we're gonna hold up. We're gonna tell them just to take her to the door, like basically where she like here. If we get her right there, you can point her to the way.
Yeah.
Okay.
There.
Okay. So you guys basically take a minute or two and walk her, and then you see as soon as she sees daylight,
yeah.
Sees daylight, she runs out and takes off running out that way.
And I gave her one gold piece.
Yep. She puts it between her teeth and bites on it to see if it's real, and then runs off. Okay, so you see her run out,
yeah,
down to the back.
In the meantime, while they're doing that, I would have told Raf to check out that other room.
So the one right across the hallway there?
Yeah.
Okay, so you go in there and you see that this room is pretty much set up the same way as the one across the hallway, except for it's empty. But you can see, you know, there's a bed in there, and you know it looks like, you know, some type of room that they would use as a nursery or something along those lines.
All right, we're gonna go room. I'm just basically going room to room, like a walk,
okay.
like a check, basically.
As you go up to the one that would be considered the northeast, I'll open it up right now just to make it clear. As you walk into this one, you can see a human female strapped to the bed. She's nude, she's gagged, and she's like shackled to the bed. And she sees you, and you can see fright in her eyes, and she's like fighting the shackles and, you know, twisting and turning and fretting and, you know, trying to back away with as much as she can as she's shackled, which isn't much.
Eldak, she's shackled here. Can you get in here and try to get these off her?
Yeah.
And then while he does that, I will go and open up this room.
Okay. Beldak, go ahead and roll your thieves' tools.
Yeah.
And that is much like the other rooms, but it's also empty.
And,
okay, and as I come,
and
as
while
I come out, I do like a clear.
And
and while I'm doing it,
you're able to
okay
to undo her bindings, and then she's like trying to do whatever she can to get away from you, and you're able to ungag her, and she's like, who are you? Don't hurt me, don't hurt me, don't hurt me, who are you? And she's crying and everything.
We're here to help you. Is there any blanket or anything like that in the room?
Any what?
Blanket. piece of...
He needs anything to cover her with.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's sheets. There's sheets on, like, the bed opposite.
You know, okay,
bed.
I'll take one of the sheets from the other beds and then hand it to her.
Okay, and she covers herself up, and she's like, get me out of here, get me out of here. They said they were coming back here for me.
And she's getting the same direction.
Okay. So... just to save time, you guys point her in the right way, and she just takes off running.
All right, these are all cleared, guys.
Good job.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Was that about a ball?
And so Roth, you're leading up front? And you're going north in the hallway. Is that the intention now?
Yes.
Yeah.
Is it Christian Grey? It's Christian Grey who's 50 Shades of Grey. My God.
Yeah. Dorian Grey is a completely different...
Right, right. He's the guy who can't die. Yeah.
Dorian's a lot less of an asshole.
My bad.
So, give me 1 second, Roth, before you move forward.
Oh, so, by the way, I cleared that. I was just keeping an eye on this corridor, like with Villara. So
okay.
I let them know the coast is clear before they go up and they fall behind.
So, Roth, you hear faintly some heavy footsteps down towards the end of the hallway going to the north.
Okay.
And in fact,
check out.
Strom, you're right behind him. In fact, you would hear it slightly as well, Strom.
Quick, go check out that door up there real quick. See if it's open. Somebody coming, I think.
Okay, so you check that door on the left and it's locked.
Shit. Let's go get him.
Do I force the door or do we go on?
We hear something come. Let's go attack them. They're coming. Let's go. Let's bum rush them. I look back and say to Mark them. You get the idea. We're going. It's on.
And as you guys are whispering back and forth, well, and actually right where Strom was, right out in front of you, stop right there.
All right.
You see, give me just one quick second. You see, that's the ladies were screaming as they're running out. Right as you come up towards the corner, you hear, smell, and see this lumbering around the corner.
Does it look like just a regular human size, or is it like a really tall, like
it's very, very, it's very tall.
How tall are these? Are these corridors?
They're probably about 8 feet.
Okay.
And he's his head's brushing up towards the top. And as he turns the corner, he sees you and he stops and he sticks out his hand towards
like
you.
What? Like just like he's
like,
trying to
like
grab
palm
it?
Up. Like he sticks his hand like palm up,
okay.
Like he's expecting, you know, like you to give him something.
Raph puts one of the pebbles from the bowl in his hand.
Okay. Hold on, I'm gonna make him visible for you. Okay, so if you remember, you had a bowl. You have 4 colors. And you can look in your inventory.
Oh, right, inventory.
Do, 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 do. Roll 6-sided dice. What it's there for?
Let the fates decide.
I don't know, Raph.
Green.
I knew he was going to say that.
Okay, so you stick green in his hand?
Yeah.
And so he looks at you, looks at his hand. And he reaches up and he tries to slam at you.
You don't like green.
Sucks because Raph's colorblind.
Yeah. And so he reaches down and slams at you, hitting you for 15 points of damage. And everybody can now roll initiative.
Holy shit, fuck.
I'd say you're mad now, huh?
yeah, there's a problem with that.
What?
We only took a short rest.
Yeah, he can't rage anymore.
Damn boy.
I ain't going anytime soon.
Well, at least it was not on a crit table.
That's right.
Give me this 1 second and then we'll be ready. As reading a whisper. Okay, so Morisari, you have first move.
Move up just a little bit.
Oh, okay. Hold on, stop right there. Let me lock tokens real quick. Okay, go ahead.
Thank God for Sniper.
You shoot an arrow and you hit him. And it sticks, and a little piece of, like, you hit him and a flap of his skin kind of falls away as that arrow hits it. And you hit him again with another one fairly close to where you hit before.
So, what were the other colors that I had in the, of stones?
You didn't write
in the inventory. You just said wooden bowl and colored stones.
Wait, hold on.
I'm looking at it right now.
Okay, wait, hold on. Just give me a second. Maybe I didn't ID it. Or maybe, did I have ID in it? Wooden bowl, colored stones. No, see, I see it. It says down below. It says wooden bowl, several colored stones, 4 blue, 5 green. 3 red, 4 yellow.
All it says is wood bowl and colored stones. That's it. End of sentence.
That's weird, because it shows ID. Now I just cycled it. You didn't see any of it?
It's one. Wood bowl and colored stones.
Did you open it up next to it?
What do you mean open it up next to it?
So, okay. Let me just talk. Look, if you look in your inventory out to the far right, you'll see like the little shield sign, the little brown dot.
Oh, okay.
Click that and it opens it up.
Ah, okay. I did not know that was...
Yeah, anytime you see one of those symbols, you can open it up.
I didn't know it would say anything on this because, you know, most things it doesn't have anything to say. And I didn't realize when you were talking about it, you meant in its description... I thought you just meant that I was supposed to have the stones in my inventory too, and I far as I could. Anyway.
Yeah.
Okay. So I will. I will hand him a red one.
Okay. So as you go to hand him a red one, he smacks it out of your hand.
Okay. So if I understand attack action thing correctly, I can't do my second attack because my first action wasn't an attack, right?
I'll say that was like your, like, it would be like a free action, like drawing a sword. I'll say that, you know,
showing,
like, was that.
Showing him the red,
yeah,
getting it smacked away.
Yeah.
Okay. So can I hit him with my shovel then?
Yes. Can you hit? And you whack him pretty good.
All right. And then can I move back here?
Yes.
Oh, right.
So it doesn't look like it likes any kind of these colors, huh, Raph?
Is he not getting an opportunity to attack?
At least not green and not red.
Alright, let's see if he likes this axe.
He don't get an opportunity to attack on Raph when he's moving away?
Yeah. Alright, so as he runs up there and he immediately hits him with his axe, battle axe.
Can he hit?
And again, I'll swing at him. And I will take my shield and I will kind of do like a halfway hit, kind of hit it with my, kind of like I'm slicing that at him with my shield. Add the bonus action.
Okay.
Ooh, there we go. Did it trigger this time?
Nope.
Oh man, three of them.
Yeah, only fumble so far that has activated.
So you're actually attacking with your shield this time, right? Yeah.
Yeah, it was. That was an attack that time.
Okay. Yeah. So he resisted.
All right. Okay. And then I will. Let's see here. I will take an opportunity attack.
Oh yeah, I missed it. I missed that on Roth.
Yeah, you got to go ahead and. I don't want to interrupt you, but you.
That's all right. That's my bad.
I'll move back, and you can have your opportunity attack.
I thought he was too slow. That's why, because I asked if he's not going to.
And so, well, I didn't hear him. So there's a lot going on. So he reaches out and takes a swing at you and misses as you're able to dodge backwards.
10,
all right.
15,
okay.
Oh shit!
Now he's back.
Well, I can't move up there, but he's so high. How can I? What do I get to shoot at him with my crossbow?
Well, you don't have sharpshooter or anything, and
nope.
You're shooting up. What?
Nope, I don't have sharpshooter or anything. He's just very tall.
So I'll just give you a -2 on the shot, since you can probably, you know, he's pretty tall.
Okay, I'll try that.
Yeah, -2 for going around. Going around Raph.
Yeah, I'm trying to.
Okay. hit. Crossbow.
Yeah, too bad that too bad Storm moved away or I got sneak attack on him, but now I didn't.
I think Storm would probably be pretty happy to not be around him. He hits pretty hard. And he resisted that.
And then I'll just load my crossbow again.
Okay. And he is going to... I'm going to roll dice real quick. He moves forward and is going to, with one hand, reach down to slam on Strong.
One question, did he resist all of my damage?
Yes.
What the fuck? Why is it different in
that? And then, so he hits you with one. For 12 points, and then he comes down with the other hand to slam down on you as well. And he misses with that hand.
Alright.
Why one question, Vera.
Okay.
Why did he resist it? Just, I don't get it, since Mosari hit him.
He resisted.
Magic weapons.
Resisted it. Alright, Velroth.
Okay.
Okay. Now, since I have sharpshooter, but there's five people in the way, but he's tall, what's your verdict? Oh.
You have sharpshooters.
Spell sniper, I mean.
Yeah, that.
Bad, you know, just
except
for
the, except for the GM, yeah. But
so he has spell sniper, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you can go ahead and take a shot at him. Jim,
watch
what's going on.
Yeah, I'm gonna quicken a firebolt to get it as a bonus action. So I spend three sorcery points for a quicken. That makes it a bonus action, so I can potentially cast it again as an action.
Okay.
Oh, that hit. Excellent. And as an action, I will cast another firebolt.
You hit?
Yes. Ooh. Both of them just sort of lance out almost simultaneously. They sort of aim for, you know, his chest and his head.
So you can see as you hit him with this just crispy, burning pieces of flesh just peeling away from his, peeling away from his body.
Okay, good.
Tastes like chicken.
Oh, God.
Marcone.
Alright, I'm going to target the flesh golem with my sacred flame as a ray of radiant light and flame strikes him.
Yeah, he succeeded.
No damage. And that's going to be my turn. Well, wait. Sorry. That was not my turn. I guess I could also do... I don't have it prepared. That sucks. I was going to do healing word, but oh well. Sorry, I can't do it.
Cleric don't have healing word?
Yeah, they do.
More, sorry.
So our cleric doesn't.
Oh, yeah. I just have cure wounds. I just didn't think it was very efficient.
Let's try this again.
Plus, it hasn't been a day, so.
Yeah, I know. I'm just joking. Razzing you.
Oops.
Yeah. Yep, so you did not trigger it, but as you shoot your first arrow, it ricochets off the wall, and like the shaft comes back and hits Marcone in the head. It doesn't hurt him or anything, but it just like the shaft shatters on the wall, and the wood flies over you.
I want to use my reaction to do lightning damage.
All right, second round. That's a little better.
Yeah.
And you gave the other guys negatives. Does she have something that allows her not to take it?
Yeah, she's got a sharpshooter.
Okay. Thank God for that.
And so you hit him and do some damage.
I'm sharpshooter and my bow is magic.
Yeah, the magic bow has nothing to do with that, though.
Okay. Yeah. Anything else after your second attack, man?
Nope. That's it.
Okay. Hit your death arrow. What do you do, Raph?
Nice.
He's lit. Like, there's just pieces of skin that have fallen off him everywhere. He's looking pretty ragged.
So, I hold up a blue stone.
Okay. And he notices it and grunts, but he's still continuing in his actions.
Okay. It doesn't seem like he's going to calm down any. Oh, wait, I need to move. I can't actually attack him.
Yeah, I tried to move back, but he moved forward. Sorry.
And you can't move through an enemy, right?
No.
Okay, well, in that case, I'm going to, I want to step back here and then ready an action to attack him if he should come within, thwacking range.
Gotcha. Hey, Strum. Hit your down arrow. Every gun, there you go. You want to describe what you just did there?
Yeah, I just took a heavy swing on him and saw he's not looking so good, trying to end his life, and I connected pretty good. And that hit him, he slammed back and fell down. Loud thump.
So you hit him right in the side of the neck, and his head separates mostly from his shoulders, except for like one little mismatched tendon is holding in as his head's hanging upside down, swinging in front of his chest. He's kind of looking at you, and then he falls backwards. And the Wyatt golems don't really communicate too much. In his dying throes, he's like, "Yellow."
Hello.
Well, of course it was yellow. That's the only color I didn't try.
All right, so
God damn it, I'm terrible.
Look at, so, here, hold on. Let's see if you guys, I'm just going to share something with all of you. So, if you were to count the bowls when you first... Oh, wait, I didn't want to do that. Doesn't really matter.
Close it out?
Yeah. I meant to copy.
Yeah, I closed it.
Yeah, just
close it. I closed it, too. I didn't see.
Oh, sorry, I'm just back now. What was that? I just closed that, correct?
Damn it. How do you make it stop sharing with people?
Right click on it and make
it. Yeah, anyhow, just close that. Here, up.
Yeah,
this is what I wanted to share with you.
I already closed that hole or something.
So, okay, so there's 5 green, 4 blue, 3 red, 4 yellow. If you were to count in the bowl, like when you first came in. Do you see why it's yellow?
No, it seems to me like it should have been red.
Why do you think it should have been red?
Those are the ones that were used.
Yeah, it's the least amount.
There's 5 letters in green, 4 letters in blue, 3 letters in red, 6 letters in yellow. 2 of the yellows were gone. Somebody took yellow.
Oh, clever.
Now, there's a deep riddle.
Sorry,
there's no way that Raph would have had the intelligence to solve that. So.
No, but that was my name, you know, yeah. All right.
I missed that. I'm not sure what you're talking about. I just got a phone call, so I had to go take that.
I was just saying...
We're all stupid.
Okay.
The riddle with the colored stones is there was 5 green stones because there's 5 letters in green, 4 blue because 4 letters in blue, 3 for red, and there should be 6 yellow along that theory, but 2 of them are gone, meaning somebody else had come down, and that was the safe. You give them a yellow, that's the safe pass.
Okay.
To get by.
Okay.
All right.
Tricky.
Anyhow, what do we do now?
All right, so these things, like do they look like humans put together?
Yeah, so it's just a big, you know, something about as tall as Raph, and it's just like pieced together from body parts.
All right, and we don't notice anything like other fish things in this thing or nothing?
Give me 1 second. Is anybody...
I'm standing next to a door, and I thought that was locked because they just moved past it. That's why I was jumping here.
Yeah, just hold on for a second. I'm looking at something. Just give me a second before. Trying to figure out what skill would most apply to knowing monsters. Would it be Arcana? Would that...
It depends on what kind of creature it is.
More than likely. If it's a natural... I'm sorry, go ahead. You were saying something.
No, I wasn't saying anything.
If it's a creature, like an animal, beast, then it would be like nature, but if it's like something that's unnatural, it would be Arcana, probably.
Yeah, so let's say anybody who's proficient in Arcana can go ahead and give me a skill roll.
Oh, hello.
And there you go. So Villaroth, he's educated. He's read some books that this would be a flesh golem.
I want to, do my thing. I'm allowed to.
What's your thing?
Ah, I see. This particular specimen is a flesh golem. It's quite apparent, but it's sewn together from multiple humans or any other humanoid creature, really. It's a specimen of much might. It takes a long time to make these things.
Raph pokes it with a shovel. I think it's just dead.
And there's a lot... We saw a locked door back there earlier, too.
Yeah, Beldak's right by the locked door. So, Beldak, what were you saying about? I think you were saying something about the door when I was looking to open up.
Yeah, before all this started, I was about to try to say, but you didn't hear me. And then the combat started, so I just stopped. But I was saying they passed the door that was locked, so I moved up to it, and I was about to go check on it, see if it's I can find traps or anything like that and open it.
Okay, so, the golem was walking towards you, so that's why I didn't really, stop to do that at that point.
He would have, the reason we went on down toward where we heard the footsteps is they were getting louder.
Yeah.
We didn't want to, be dinking around with the door and get surprised.
No, that's okay. I was just saying I'll do that at the same time that was supposed to. But never mind.
Okay. I would just say, for future reference, when we come in, we roll initiative, and there's a monster coming, if you want to check a door, you need to do that on your initiative.
Yeah, perfect.
So, otherwise, it's impossible for me to run combat and try and run side things.
No, I know.
That would basically be his action.
Yeah, I know, but I was doing this before the combat. That's what I'm talking about. But never mind.
No, because it wasn't before combat. Because we went up there to try to open it, and as soon as it was locked, like Raph said, we immediately rushed forward.
Yeah, and he was coming towards you, so you were forced into combat. You wouldn't have had time to do that. So, anyhow, so go ahead. You're there now. If you want to search for tracks or traps or pick the lock or
first I want to see if I can see anything through a keyhole, or if there is a keyhole, and so on.
There's on that one. There's it's kind of your standard door. There a latch and a key. Excuse me. So as you're looking over the door, you don't notice anything trap wise with the door. It is locked, and as you're looking at it, to you it looks like a fairly simple mechanism that if you were to try and pick it, I'd give you advantage on it. And so you're easily able to go ahead and open this door, and do you go ahead and open it now, or?
Nope. I'll just tell Morricay, tell them the door is open.
Okay, so you just unlocked it. You're not going to open it up?
Yeah, I'm just letting them in front know that I opened the door behind us now.
All right, go check it out.
All right. Well, if you let me through, I'll open the door.
So you can kind of pass your way through if everybody's going to let you in. And so when you open the door, you can see that this room is well adorned. It has a comfortable feel to it. There's no dust inside. It's an immaculate room. The light's dim. There's a single sconce for light. The air seems drier than most of the place where you've been walking. It smells of fresh flowers. It's quite obvious that's from a bouquet on the small table in the room. There's a small but comfortable looking bed, and the wall above the bed is a religious symbol that you don't recognize.
So it's a religious symbol.
Okay, so,
and hold on, let me open the room up for you. You can actually see a little bit more, sorry. Oops. Here you go.
So Raph's going to check this door.
Okay. So you open that one, and in that room, there's the privies in there, and then just a couple like chairs to sit around. Basically, some room you'd maybe go to a rest. It's a basic medieval bathroom.
All right. Raph will basically just start making his way around the room.
Okay.
And as he comes to doors, he's just going to start opening them. And he's not going to be in any particular hurry about this, so if others start coming in,
we'll probably
get there before he gets all the way around.
We're going to follow you. Now, the religious symbol we see in that room... Is it something that maybe I can point out to somebody else? If I saw it, I wouldn't really know anything about it myself, but maybe as like Marcone and Vilroth come in, I would just kind of, you know, pay attention to it.
Yeah, you need to be trained in it, correct?
Sorry, I had to come back.
Not much of a scholar in religion.
And what the hell is that thing?
So if you're proficient in religion, you can go ahead and roll a religion check on it.
Perhaps if you point out its name.
So, Marcone, you would recognize this as a symbol from the Church of Krabrathi. Here, let me, I'll pop that in.
It's a church.
It's a church. Yeah, it's a church that that is quite large and well known on the mainland.
Yeah, it's a well known deity, less powerful than my god. Krabrathi.
Perhaps they like seafood.
Anything in there. So like I said, you have let me close this out so I'm reading or anything. It's got a comfortable feel. It's definitely nicer than everything else you've seen in here so far. And it smells nice. The bed's nicely made.
Is that the two small rooms where there is a door into that's three beds, correct?
Yeah. The one to the south is a privy. The one to the top is like a there's some books stored in there, and, you know, it's like a closet, and there's some, you know, personal effects stored in there.
Okay. I'd like to make an investigation check in this room.
Then the one to the north?
Yeah.
Okay, so as you're looking around in there, you can go ahead and roll your check. Okay, so you as you're looking around in that room. You see some books and some clothing hung up in there. You can tell that it's definitely the clothing is, you know, religious nature, robes and stuff like that. The books are mostly of a religious nature as well.
It's more like I'm checking if there's anything of value, taking a book out, looks value, no, throw it on the floor, next one. Just going through to see if there's any value.
So if you're looking in there, you know, you can go through that routine. You don't find much in there.
Okay.
Is anybody else going to look around the room, or what else are you guys doing?
I'm going to open the door that's next to me.
Okay. So it's locked, but it's locked from your side. And anybody else that's looking around, you can do a perception check or investigation if you're doing something specific, tell me. If you're just looking around the room, you can do, you know, perception. If you're actually physically investigating, let me know what you're doing in role investigation.
No, I would just be waiting for, I would just be, as he locks, as he sees that the door is locked, I'm just waiting for Beldak to come try to unlock it for us.
Okay.
Well, it's locked from this side. Ralph will just unlock it and open the door.
So, yeah. So you're able to unlock the door there. Morsar, you notice a book sitting on the table that looks like a rather nice leather-bound book. And Marcone, you notice there might be something under the bed.
I'll check out the book.
I'll check out the bed.
Yeah, fuck it, I'll roll one too.
So, give me investigation on those each individual things. Vilroth, you would have noticed the book on the table as well.
And I'm going to the other room to the south when I'm done.
So if you want to look at the book further, go ahead and roll.
Nice.
Yeah, 20.
Yeah, man, Mark. Okay, so.
Oh my god.
So, Vilaroff, you're kind of looking at the book, and you kind of seem at a loss. And Morsari walks up, and she's like, "Well, this looks like some type of spell book. Seems quite obvious."
Says the non-caster.
Yeah, yeah.
I have no.
Well, I do have some spells.
Yeah. So, so you realize that that is Morsari, that is some type of spell book there on the table, and then Marcone, you kind of see something under the bed. You bend down, you look under there, and you see a chest under the bed. Not a huge chest, but you know, not a tiny, you know, not a small one either. It's a good medium sized chest.
D's, oh, C's, okay. I laugh at my own jokes.
Yeah.
But tis. So I like look around and like everybody might hey. Valdek?
Yep.
Might want to come take a look at this. Everybody else, I think I found.
Is that to the north in that room I was in?
So I have him take a look.
It's not in the room you were in, Valdek. It's in the main room.
Okay.
There's a bed in there.
Okay.
I sort of call out and I like pull it out from under the bed. I'm like, and I sort of Captain Morgan one leg on it. And I'm like, look what I found. I was like, who wants to bet there's cool stuff inside?
Okay. I'll take a look at it, and then I will try open it with my mage hand from a distance. And I'll tell everybody to move away.
Okay. So where are you in relation to the chest as you open it?
Yeah, I need to know where it is. I can't see.
Well, that's okay. So let's say, well, I mean, just kind of theater of mind it. Are you, like, there's a, the bed is right there beside the door. Okay? And so you pull the chest out. Are you standing to the side of the chest? Are you standing behind it? Are you standing in front of it when you do the mage hand? Like, just, you know, give me a relation.
I'll probably go in this room where the door is. And when the door is open, I'll just, so I'm silent, and then I'll tell everybody to move out. Or wait.
Okay. And so there's a lock on the chest.
Yep.
What are you doing with your mage hand?
Open it.
Okay, so you're going to try and pick the lock?
Yep.
Okay, so you roll me your thieves' tools.
Yep.
Okay, so as you start working on this lock, you hear some clicking noises, click, 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 and then also, and a dart shoots across the room right into the wall. But working at it a couple more minutes, you're able to unlock the chest.
Okay. Then I'll tell everybody, okay, you can come in now, and the chest is open.
Okay, so as you look through the chest, there's a figurine in there. Doesn't, you know, nothing, you know, too fancy. Just trying to pick out what, you know, there's some quartz in there, and I'll go ahead. I'm gonna throw this in the inventory tracker. There's quite a bit of coinage in there. And hold on one second, let me drag this over. The spell book was on the table, so and let me find your spell book up. You guys have identified it, so.
And all the other things is in that chest?
Yeah, so some of this stuff's just around the room, and some of it's in the chest. So that's basically some of the stuff's just on the table, like the paper and the ink pen and stuff, but the holy water and the quartz and all the coinage and the figurine and the cloth gold vestments, a lot of that stuff was in the chest.
Okay.
So if you're gonna carry it out, go ahead and drag it over to your
Wilrod, can you see if anything has any magical value here?
Sure. I'll do a detect magic ritual.
Okay. Then you guys take the time of that.
Yeah, we're gonna have to hold up here a little bit. It's gonna take 10 minutes.
Yeah. But instead of just taking it all with us, I think it's easier that way.
So, as you do this, you know, you can hear things kind of echoing through the lower floors. You don't necessarily get any type of reading off of any of this stuff that's in the party sheet in there right now. There's no magical readings off of that.
I just stand up for my magic and rainbows and just, no magic.
Yeah, I assume you guys are going to just kind of split the coins up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right, so I'll go ahead and issue that stuff to you right now.
So there's nothing, there's any magical value in here, you say?
No.
Okay.
Not even the spell book?
Yeah, I was just wondering that.
Well, the spell book is, you know, it's a standard spell book. You know, there's spells in the book. I don't know, would that read magical?
That's magical.
Yeah, okay, so then you get a reading out the book.
Oh, fair enough. Can I do an arcana on the book to see if I can discern what magic it is?
Yeah. So, you kind of are looking through it. Let me, I have to kind of roll or kind of add a little bit into it, but, you know, you've heard through town that I'm not going to tell you that. Never mind. Here. So that's what you're able to see right down there.
Now, anything that anybody else doesn't take, Raf will pick up. So once everybody's done picking up what they're going to pick up, Raf will pick up the rest.
There is a potion of healing in there too. You guys can probably see that.
Yep. So that spell book, did you find anything out, Wilrod?
Well, I know what's in there now, right?
Yeah, you should be able to see the spells. I should have.
Yeah, okay, yeah. Well, there's 2 or 4 spells in here. There's 2 simple spells. There's a fog cloud and an unseen servant spell. 2 are a bit more powerful.
What source is it?
Let me finish. It's a sleet storm and a tidal wave. Both are area spells, as far as I know.
Well, I was more thinking about, is it wizard, sorcerer, druid, what kind?
These are mostly wizard spells.
Okay.
That's all I can use.
Yeah, then I can also probably use some of them, maybe. But we can find out that later. I think Raf, you should take that healing potion and just use it, because you are heavily damaged, and then I also will cast Cure Wounds on him.
Okay.
I don't think you're like am I correct in saying that, Steven, our rogue tricksters, arcane tricksters, they're not like wizards, so they can't just write stuff in their spell books, right?
I don't think they get spell books.
Yeah, I don't think it's...
So same thing with sorcerers, they just like learn spells.
Yeah, you ain't like a wizard where you actually can write them down in your spell book and you know them, so it wouldn't be any good.
Yeah, we can keep it solid, I suppose.
All right, so go ahead and take whatever you're going to take and cast your cure wounds on him if that's what you're going to do.
I'm already.
And then,
oh my god.
Ralph's got a door open there. What do you guys do from here?
Is there anything? Is there anything on the other side? I mean, is that a hallway on this open door?
Yeah. So I'm just going to go ahead and kind of open up a little bit of that hallway, figuring you stick your head out there.
Oh, I totally forgot I can cast it as a higher level.
There you go. So if you stick your head out and look both ways, that's what you would see.
Door up there?
Big hallway. Big hallway. So how would I use a potion of healing? Do I just drop the shield on my character?
You can, and I'll go in maybe at some point and just, if you don't have on your sheets, I'll make a little effect.
But I have a power for it.
Well, I mean.
Okay. But basically, you can just roll a 2d4 and add 2 to it, and then I'll change it on the combat checker.
I've got mine set to target, so it's just,
okay.
Okay, if you got yours set to target, just go ahead and roll.
So is it Raph?
Yeah, and, create one. I'll create one on everybody else's sheet in between next game.
I already have made one for all the potions.
And so I took the potion out of the parcel items and drank it.
Okay. Perfect.
And so, why don't you take the other one that was on the table? Oh, is that the one that you just drank? Never mind.
Yeah.
Probably just explain that. Okay. Not bad. All right, cool.
Okay, so is anybody taking this stuff? Or, Roth, are you going to take all that stuff?
I'm just going through a see
what it is right giving, now. I'm giving everybody a chance. And is everybody done?
Nope.
I think I'll grab the gems. I'm a man of finery.
Yeah, you guys can
sell
those and divide it later or whatever,
Yeah, Raph's strong. Let him carry it.
I'll try to.
The unidentified item?
Yeah, that's why I was also wondering, since there was no magical.
Which one?
Below, it's saying unidentified item.
Okay, well, let me look through. I don't.
It's down at the bottom.
Yeah, for us it says unidentified.
And I was going through all those gems to see if any of that had the worth of like 100 gold, so I know I could use that for identify next time. But then they disappeared, just so you know it.
Yeah, perhaps like taking them one by one.
Nah, I think Villa took all that.
We're slowly seeing just like all these items disappearing in Raph's stuff.
I don't know how to take more than one.
You have to drag them over all the time.
Yeah.
That's what I'm doing. One at a time.
What the fuck? I took the quartz and then I got the unidentified item.
So where is the unidentified item now?
No, it's on Beldak.
Probably in Raph's.
No,
in Raph's.
No, it's on Beldak.
Oh, Beldak stole it.
No, I was trying to take the quartz, but then I think he took that at the same time.
Yeah, everything shows identified on my side.
Hmm.
So it's weird. Like, everything shows ID'd.
But if you check the party, or the text, you're saying unidentified items on Beldak. But I can't see it on my inventory. Oh, there it is.
I don't know if that's a glitch. I don't see it.
You don't see it on my inventory either? From 5th
below?
Oh, wait,
below. Yeah, okay, nope, I found it. Hold on, I found it. Oh, so weird.
Cool, a gem for 10,000 gold. Yeah.
It's just a whistle made from gold-colored wood. There's nothing magical about it. All right. So, okay, let's press on. We got about 15 more minutes here if you guys want to go do something else in here.
All right.
Now I'm just trying to find that item you made so I can put it over to inventory again so they can take it.
It says a whistle made from gold-colored wood.
Okay, got it.
All right, we'll check out this, Raph, let's check out this door here. I'm going to see if this door is open.
So that door's locked.
Okay. Where's Baldak?
Oh, never mind, I'll take that with me. I can maybe use it for fun. And then I'm going
on. I'm looking around Raph's legs to see if he's, like, hidden behind his legs that I don't see him.
Hey, I'm going to move you just for a minute so I can grab the pin that's actually under you. Okay. So there's a door there, and it appears to be locked.
Oh.
All right, then I'll keep looking for... Oh, then I saw him. There he is. Locked door, buddy. Oh, over here.
Nope, my mate hand is not good on that. Unless it was an easy one also, so I'd get adventures.
So you're able to unlock the door, and you hear the handle click, and you can tell, you know, even with your mage hand that the lock's unlocked.
Okay, it's open. I'm just saying. Why are you? Never mind.
All right, time and let's open it up, and we'll go in.
So who's opening the door?
I'll open it.
Okay, so as you turn the handle and go to push on the door,
mm-hmm.
and it doesn't really, but it doesn't open. You hear it like rattle, like it kind of like, you know, like moves not even an inch, but it moves a little bit, like it rattles and everything, but something's impeding it from opening.
All right, I'm gonna like really push on it really hard, like I'm gonna ram it with my shoulder.
Okay, go ahead and roll strength for athletics, right? And so you hit it, and it flexes, but still doesn't give.
Then I'll look over at Raph and say, "Hey, you can give it. Want to give this a hit?"
Sure. I'll try. Raph steps up.
And you hit it, and you can hear wood cracking and splintering. And the door comes off it, you know, you hear a crack, and it just immediately gives way. And, you know, the door comes off its hinges, and it was obviously barred with some type of wood on the other side. Just breaks free. And,
Raph rides the door into the room like a surfboard. No, just kidding.
And,
you
can see...
Not near enough dexterity for that.
You can see another, door down at the other end.
Alright, well, he was ahead.
Yep. And as you go in there, the door swings open from the other side, and
another Lovecraftian horror steps out.
Yep.
Got it.
Yep. So, hold on, just identifying.
Trying to find the specific Lovecraftian horror.
Exactly. So, as it opens, you'll see that guy. You'll see this guy. And that guy. And let me open up a little bit more of the map, and you guys can go ahead and roll initiative. Nobody really gets surprised. They heard you coming. the door opens. Yeah. I mean, if anything, you would be surprised, but...
I'm sure after that door...
Yeah. We knocked. They know we're coming.
Yeah.
That is a long hallway. Oh, yeah, there it is. Got it.
All right. So, everybody go ahead and roll initiative. Now, so we got like 13 minutes. You guys want to play out this combat now, or do you want to save it for next time?
I think next time, because I'm pretty sure it'll take longer.
I don't care. It's up to me. It doesn't matter.
Unless
I do, I like the round.
Here, hold on.
We can finish it now.
Boop. Okay, go ahead and boop. You want to?
I'm just saying I don't want to stop in the middle, but if we can just finish it and then it may be 10 more minutes overtime, I don't care. Then I'll just stay.
Yeah.
To be honest, I don't have 10 minutes of overtime. So
then we can start next time.
Yep.
Okay. Alright.
Yeah,
so,
I'm good either way.
Okay. So. Well.
Yeah, we'll I'm fine.
Yeah, okay. We'll, we can finish it and somebody else can play out your character, or we can just hold it the next time. It doesn't matter to me either.
Just hold it.
Okay,
yeah,
so we'll
hold it.
It.
I'm fine.
Okay. So next time when we come back, we will... So what you see here, as you open the door, you see several beds in there. And, where's the one? There's, and as soon as that door opens, it's just hot, humid air comes bellowing out of there, and it smells not only fishy, but it smells of sickness. It's you can hear in there some sobbing and whispers and people. You can hear kids crying and all types of stuff in there.
Nasty, nasty.
So, that'll be next time. So,
for tonight,
I will, for what we finished defeating, I'll award you some XP. So, there's another 375. There's going to be some backloaded next time for some things you killed, don't worry. Award for your interrogation of the Deep One and for what people you've rescued so far. And that should bring us up for XP tonight. You guys are carrying loot you can do something with later. And I will say that the Deep One in the back is... His robes are a little bit nicer than the one in front.
All right.
And we will call it there.
Okay.
Pretty good.
And we play in 2 weeks again.
Yeah, so we'll play in 2 weeks.
Yep.
Sounds good.
Anybody got anything? Any questions? Anything they want to throw out?
I don't know.
Not right now.
What was that?
I'm just gonna go. Not any questions, no inquiries.
Okay.
I'm just gonna
cool.
go.
All right.
See you guys later.
Yep. Talk to you soon.
Have a good one.
Yep.
Yep. Bye.
Hey, Wolfie, how do you end a host?
You just type /unhost.
Yeah.
And then the name.